going to hear can easily understand.
And now it's time for the voice. Voice.
Don't know how to put this, but I'm kind of a big deal.
I want you to get up right now
and go to the window,
open it,
stick your head out and yell,
"Hayden Bond, top of the world!"
The voice of Ocala with Buddy Martin.
You know I don't speak Spanish. In English, please.
Look in my eyes, what do you see? The cult of personality. Dreams. I've been everything you wanna be. Oh, I'm the cult of personality. Like Mussolini and Kennedy. I'm the cult of personality. The cult of personality. The cult of personality.
Hello, welcome to a Thursday edition of The Voice of Ocala. Buddy Martin with you, as we are every weekday here from 3 to 6, the first 2 hours, news, views, interviews, information. The last hour, 5 to 6, of course, is the sports page. And we got plenty for you today. At 4:15, Laurie Martin Gregory comes in to speak about two important things. One of them is Z-Pak's antibiotics, something she's been talking about for a long time.
And I can't wait to hear about that.
Yeah, more information on that came out this week. Also, busy sports hour today. Morgan Lucas, who won in the Gator Nationals last year in Gainesville, was on our show prior to that. And, of course, we're the good luck charm. We gave him the good karma. And now Tom has booked Morgan Lucas today at 5:15.
Morgan booked himself. He called and said, "Look, yeah, I need to be on the show."
Yeah, yeah.
He gives us all the credit for him winning top field last year.
And he should. So, because we have that kind of karma. And then big day OBS this week. Record-breaking sale tied the record for the most money, $1.8 million Colt. And among other things he'll talk about will be that is Michael Compton, who shares his knowledge on the horses with us today at 5:30. It's time to talk about basketball, SEC basketball. Gators tomorrow playing, I guess, the winner of Georgia-LSU at 1 o'clock, and Fransbury will give us a preview of that game. All happening today right here on your local program, your only afternoon local radio program in Marion County, The Voice of Ocala. Your program belongs to you. Now, today the news starts out with, first of all, another cruise ship. Another cruise ship.
Can you believe this?
This is a remarkable story. I don't know what's
6,000 passengers.
This is Carnival. You know, they got one coming back to the
Carnival
port.
Dream.
And they're going to be more news about that. But right now, right off the bat, we're just going to say that, you know what? Not a good time to be taking cruises, apparently, especially if you're on Carnival Dream. We'll tell you about that in a moment. Also, today, I told you about Matt Lauer earlier this week, about the story I read in the Daily Beast about Matt Lauer, the long interview he did. And today, the New York Times comes out with a front page story saying a new low for Matt Lauer. So he continually, I guess his problems aren't over by a long shot. Then you read about the horrendous murder, of course, double murder at the local motel here on Pine Street. Now there was a marijuana bus out there. Someone arrested. So I guess a lot of bad things happening out there at that motel these days.
Do you know where the motel is, buddy?
Vacation Inn. I was trying to place
it. It's a horrendous spot.
It's not surprising to anyone that knows where the hotel is located that these kind of events are taking place there.
Well, I'm not expecting it, you know. I'm not expecting it's going to be over in Belle Chasse someplace, you know, or something like that.
No, if the mayor had his way, he would shut the hotel down.
Yeah, well, they have some of those issues. You know, and there is a mixed message there because there are people who need places to stay. You know, I mean, I get that, and you don't want to throw people out, but by the same token, and the cops were there. Marion County Sheriff's Department was there before this and tried to deal with the issue of hand this guy, and long story today, Star Banner, and apparently had no grounds to arrest him, and then of course he winds up killing two people. So the vacation host might want to think maybe about renaming that.
It's out past 31st on Pine, headed towards Bellevue, on the right hand side of the road.
Yeah, so that's a horrible story. So also today, I was out at the Junior Achievement Breakfast, and nice turnout at the Hilton. some of the folks out there. Kevin Reed got a big kudo for a group of high school kids who started their own little business selling coffee from Great American Roasters. And this is a project of their own. I looked at their figures up on the screen. They projected $1 million. I thought maybe I'm in the wrong business. I should get in the coffee business. But these youngsters are doing it all by themselves. And really impressive bunch of young people doing something and starting early. Great table there sitting around with Tom Ingram and Frank and Michelle DeLuca. Angie Lewis is there. Bart Blessing, Tito Comas, on and on and on. Lots of people.
We never get invited to those, JJ.
No.
You notice that?
I'm not surprised by that.
We never get invited.
You know why? They know you won't be up at 8 o'clock.
And let's be honest, if there was an achievement between the two of us, it would only be a junior achievement. We wouldn't have any senior achievements.
Well, it's not about our achievements. It's about supporting the kids, you know?
Yeah.
And I sat next to the chief of police, and we talked about helicopters a little bit. So
that's where I'd probably have to sit,
and by the way,
for completely different reasons, though.
Yeah. Just saying one thing. I know we've poked fun at him and talked about him and all that stuff. This morning about 4 o'clock, I was awakened to this thunderous chop, 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 chop. My wife thought the chopper was landing on our house.
I'm telling you.
And then there was a second one later on. And Lori, she said at one point earlier that night, she said her windows were rattling. They're out there. It's all about, we know now what it is. We'll talk about that in a moment. But even the chief said he's getting more calls now about it. So it continues to be an issue for us, and we'll talk about it. And not too much we can do about it, considering who is running the show. Let's see. What else we got going on today? A new segment. More than just a rumor. All right? More than just a rumor.
The city's negotiating with the Yankees about bringing the Yankees here.
No, that's not it. It could be that maybe the city's got the Yankees.
Oh, okay.
But that would be worse than a rumor. I guess you could say that would be less than a rumor. Because if it's less than a rumor, maybe this should be called less than a rumor instead of more than a rumor. What more than just a rumor is, means there's something to it. All right? Now, rumors, we don't like to speculate with rumors too often, but every now and then we hear one that sounds kind of true. But a couple of things that we're going to talk about. What's up with CF's bid to become host of the State Junior College Basketball Tournament? May have a little something, I'm pretty sure, tell you about that. And I had to hear about this secondhand, which I was not very happy about. I told my friend so. What's up with Tom Ingram and Ron Zook out at Lake Weir?
Uh-oh.
Something going on there, cooking, and then there's another one about
I have one I've heard, so I know you want to ask three, and you probably got three, but I'm interjecting.
I probably got
one
five. Go ahead.
There's something I've heard. There's a rumor about a book writing.
JJ going to ESPN.
I didn't say
that's
there was.
That's not even a rumor.
I didn't say there was pure fantasy. Now calm down.
But I'm going to change the game there, buddy.
You could. You would do good at it.
I've heard a rumor about a book being written, and I got to ask somebody. I want to know. I'm going to get to the bottom of it.
All right. Well, we'll talk about that, too. You know, think of that. Think of some good ones you'd like to hear. You know? Like JJ going to ESPN. But what would be nice to hear a nice rumor?
That the general public, business leaders in this community would love to shower the Voice of Ocala with sponsorships.
That would be good, wouldn't it?
That'd be a great rumor if we could bring that around.
Well, we ought to make that happen anyway.
You know what? They could do it, too. Just all you got to do is call 732-8000 and ask for Tom.
There you go. And by the way, we are really pleased with the response we've been getting about those things from our good friends and sponsors and people and new sponsors and our old sponsors. We got a group of people who have been with us for a long time. And I'm going to tell you something. I'll always appreciate them because they were with us back when.
Yes.
How many months is it now?
Been
before we left the other station. Some of these other people will be at the other station.
July of 2010. Was it July? July of 2011.
September 2011.
Yeah, we came here in September 2011, but I started working for you in July of 2011.
Yeah. So what is that now in terms of this station, JJ? Are you counting how many? You've been here since day one.
Yeah.
So that would be September, August. October, November, December, January, August February. So we're talking like 18 months now.
Right.
So, and in 4 more months, I've got some sponsors have been with me over 2 years, which is just fantastic, and I'll always appreciate them. But we could always use some more. Like Tom said, give us a call, and we've got to fix you up there. All right, we'll step aside. We'll come back. We'll address a few things like this carnival cruise disaster they got going on. Also, I'll tell you about the Matt Lauer story, and lots more to come your way right here on the Voice of Ocala. Stay tuned.
On 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, streaming live at WOCA.com. The source.
Every day we hear another story about innovation or about cutting-edge technology taking place right here in Ocala. The power plant, IHMC, Ocala 489. Did you know that important medical research is also being conducted here that may impact hundreds of thousands of people in the country someday? Maybe you've heard the name Renstar, but like so many others, perhaps you didn't realize that Renstar Medical Research is one of the top facilities of its kind anywhere in the U.S. There are important research studies being conducted by a highly qualified team of medical experts at Renstar, impacting decisions of major pharmaceutical companies and bringing new drugs to market. And you can be a part of these studies, as so many local people have done and are currently doing. Renstar has conducted more than 500 studies since its inception and would like to extend the opportunity to you to be a part of these cutting-edge programs. Call 877-629-5800 or 352-629-5800 if you'd like to know more. Renstar Medical Research, locally owned and operated in beautiful downtown Ocala. Renstar, seeking tomorrow's answers to the health questions of today.
Hi, this is Tom Schmitz, the host of Buddy's Saturday Sports Page on WOCA. The Saturday Sports Page is your weekend destination for everything sports, from NASCAR to golf, baseball to boxing, and of course, the best, most comprehensive football coverage on the radio. Also, you don't want to miss my weekly Are You Kidding Me rant? So join me and JJ LaSalva every Saturday morning at 10 a.m. for Buddy's Saturday Sports Page on WOCA, The Source.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And so is State Farm agent Angie Lewis, working hard to serve her community as a citizen and insurance agent. Angie wants to help you as you adjust your insurance needs to your life. From everything to helping educate your teen driver to protecting your family against everyday risk. She wants to change the way you perceive insurance by developing relationships with her clients, which is why Angie and her staff are proud to be a part of so many good causes in Ocala. In turn, she has chosen to single out those who step up as leaders. Each month on the Voice of Ocala, Angie spotlights a good neighbor, saluting those who give exceptional service or do random acts of kindness to others. For this, Angie was written up in State Farm's National Magazine. Angie also supports local businesses with a regular Biz Buzz. The Angie Lewis State Farm Agency is located at 1122 Northeast 36th Avenue, where visitors are always welcome and the coffee pot is always on. Call your good neighbor's State Farm agent today, Angie Lewis, at 294-2444.
Hello, this is Dr. Riyad Fakhri, chiropractic orthopedist at the Fakhri Medical and Chiropractic Center. Listen in to the Head to Toe Care Show every Wednesday, 11 a.m., right here on WOCA. Learn how your body works so that you can help yourself. We're available to answer your questions every Wednesday at 11 a.m. on WOCA, The Source. That's Dr. Riyad Fakhri on the Head to Toe Care Show every Wednesday, 11 a.m., right here on WOCA, The Source.
Sound of the bat cracking, the crowd cheering, the smell of overpriced but tasty hot dogs, the memories that will last a lifetime of your first baseball game with little Johnny. Your team wins. It was a great night until you get home. It's 9 p.m. and your wife says you have no water.
We have no water.
What do you do?
What do you do?
Rule number one, don't panic. Remain calm. Okay, that's two rules.
We don't have time for jokes, funny man.
Okay, think back. On the way home, you heard a radio commercial.
Mike's got plumbing. If water runs through it, we do it.
Eureka! You saved the day. You remembered that Mike Scott Plumbing doesn't charge extra for nights, weekends, or holidays. You are a genius.
Hey, Mr. Genius, did you remember the phone number?
Of course you did. Remember, you're a genius. 352-237-2888. Because at Mike Scott Plumbing, if water runs through it, we do it. Even if water's not running through it at this particular moment. Mike Scott Plumbing.
Hi, I'm Russ with Climate Control Mechanical Services, and I want to invite you to tune in every Thursday at 10:30 a.m. to listen for tips and answers to the many questions you may have about your air conditioning and heating for your home or business. The Climate Control Show, every Thursday at 10:30 a.m. right here on WOCA, 1370 a.m. and 96.3 FM, The Source.
This is Tom Schmitz live in the WOCA studios with this news break brought to you by the Country Club of Ocala. This is for all conspiracy theorists out there. Ocala has put up with some loud aircraft flying over the city since Saturday night, as military aircraft have been flying over as part of a training exercise. Major Mike Burns of MacNeil Air Force Base in Tampa said that the 4-8 Black Hawk and Chinook helicopters that have been flying over are part of a larger training exercise overseen by the U.S. Special Operations Forces. The training is to prepare participants for overseas mission in urban areas. The exercise is scheduled to continue until Friday. So, we are not being invaded by our own military people. It's a training exercise. This news break was brought to you by the Country Club of Ocala. If you'd like to schedule a special event at one of Ocala's premier facilities, call 237-6644 today.
This little bit of you I got, it ain't good enough. Yeah, you got me all messed up.
All right, so what are those little green men around running around my house last night? Well, I want to know.
That is, now, see, that's Marvin the Martian, and he's got his P-38 modulator.
Okay.
So he's...
I wondered, because...
he's looking for Bugs Bunny.
I mean, I've heard him the last couple of nights, but, I mean, last night was, like, thunderous. And I talked to the chief today at the Union Achievement Breakfast, and he said that he hadn't heard him troll just a couple of nights ago. Now he's hearing him.
So now the chief's thinking... Please tell me he knows what's going on.
He does. He said, I guess you saw where it came. I said, yeah, I read the news about where they came from. It is a military ops training site. And I guess there's a story explained that you just read. They're really coming from MacDill. And,
right.
You know, and we just happen to be in the pathway. We're not part of, they're not like descending down the streets here and, you know, having a fake battle. They're just passing over. But those Chinooks, they must fly at like 20 feet. Because, I mean, they're right on top of you. You said you had some Blackhawks last night.
I had some Blackhawks last night. But contrary to beliefs of some people at this radio show, they're not looking for you. So relax, JJ.
I never said they were. It's just annoying. I hate it.
Well, no, I don't think JJ said he's not a conspiracy theorist. He just said it's unusual.
Yeah.
He hadn't heard of it. And it's if you haven't heard of it, and like Laurie hadn't really heard much about it, And you hear it, and it's rattling your windows at your house. It's kind of scary a little bit, you know? I mean, let's be honest about it.
And you know what's scary is, now I know that our local police force can't do a damn thing if they wanted to come in here and do anything.
Well, not about
that. They didn't even know. You know, like, they came out and were saying they don't know what it is. That makes me feel great.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's sad.
But see, they have to have FAA clearance and all that to get this far.
I guess it's above.
But they don't have to have local Marion County.
But wait, it's above their grade to tell them where they can fly and where they can't. You know, but there is a disconnect there, JJ. You're right about the fact that they're not informed.
You know, a lot of people were asking Blair and the people that were running, a lot of our listeners. Okay, well, what would you do if there was a federal law that said, you know, come get our guns or whatever, and they would do their best they can, they said, but that they can't do nothing.
Well, it's too bad we haven't got a show where we have the chief of police and the sheriff.
Oh, wait a minute. That will be asked. I wish they were doing it this
next Friday.
And it's brought to you by Daniel Hightower, attorney at law.
Nice.
Yes, it is. And so that's a good question to ask, but I think JJ makes a valid point, is that it kind of surprised me when the chief said, I don't have any idea.
Right.
Although I understand now why he didn't, and I can see why nobody, you know, let's face it, CIA's not going to call the local police and
Thank you.
Say, hey,
by the way, we're doing special ops in your area
about 9 o'clock at night. It'll be me. Don't worry about it. But there is something. And you hear these stories all the time about agencies not talking to each other. You see these shows on TV where an FBI guy shows up in a case and a local cop shows up and they say, this is my territory.
Get out of here.
You know, so maybe some of that's true. I don't know.
It's
a very good question to talk to our top cops on Ask the Cops a week from Friday, Gateway Bank. And you know what? What's cool about it is they'll answer it. Yeah.
You know, I guess the reason I don't think it's that big a deal is living where I lived for 20 years in South Georgia with Hunter Army Airfield and Fort Stewart, which is the 24th Mechanized Infantry Division, and the Army Rangers, and they were always training right over your house constantly. So I guess. If you're not used to them doing it on a daily basis, where in Statesboro, you got something buzzing your house on a daily basis.
Well, I used to live in Melbourne by Patrick Air Force Base, and it was every day, all day. But I knew why they were there.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I don't know why they're there this time.
It's not out of context. You know, a lot of people don't know there's a bombing range in the forest for the Navy.
A huge bombing range.
And they find every now and then bombs that didn't go off out there.
People, and
live, I'm talking about live bombs.
And people don't realize, when you say a bombing range for the Navy, you mean there's a bombing range in the forest that Navy ships sitting 100 miles offshore are using. That's the thing. They're firing missiles from 100 miles offshore.
I don't think they're missiles. These are jets.
But there's not a guy out there one of those old timey black
This is for naval pilots
out there
like, shooting their rockets.
Oh, I thought it was for naval ships too.
No,
I thought that bombing range was the same.
No, not firing any rockets off of ships. Okay. It's just that that's been forever since they have jets. They've been flying out there in a bombing range. But you know, I don't believe they'll call the local chief or call.
No,
the
they don't let them
say,
know
hey,
either.
Be bombing at 0800 tonight. Just check it out. You know. So anyway, it's kind of a different kind of story. Kind of unusual. And the chief said he heard it now, and he understands why people get a little concerned about it. So, all right, so coming up at 4:15, Laurie Martin Gregory addresses a couple of things. A Z-Pak antibiotics, not good for you, as has been proven apparently now, at least in one case, and they could be damaging to other parts of your body. And then there's a list of nutrition lists for food companies, which they just rank them in according to order and according to the ones that do the best job. And I'll see if Laurie wants to tackle that. Also, I've got, I don't know if we'll get to it today, this interesting story about the 10 businesses in our country that benefit most from war. And one of them has an office here in Marin County.
Ooh.
I'll
That's
tell you about
different.
That. Yeah. In other words, obviously these people build things that help with war. Well, so we'll tell you about that a little bit later on, too.
Well, buddy, can we get to the dream story?
Yeah, go ahead. I think it's comical. I mean, I don't know if Saturday Night Live has done this skit yet, but I'm sure
they need to.
Because so, this is happening again.
So the Carnival Dream was docked in St. Martin. And they did a test on the generators and all. They fired the ship up after when it's getting ready to do port. The generator, a signal said the generators weren't working properly. So they said, oh, it's something minor, because this ship's
technical issue.
A relatively new ship. Ship's less than 5 years old, which in the shipping business is a new ship.
Where are they getting their ships from? The junkyard?
I guess. So, well, they worked all day to try to get it fixed, all night, and then in the middle of the night decided they can't fix it. So it's stranded in St. Martin with over 4,000 passengers, 2,000 crew members, for over 6,000 people. Now they're chartering jets, JJ, to bring them back to Orlando to put them on buses to take them to Port Canaveral from St. Martin. And if you don't know where St. Martin is, the greatest way to Google St. Martin is Google jet fly over St. Martin. St. Martin's the island where the jet comes right in over the beach, and it looks like you can reach up and touch the jet as it's landing.
I've been there.
Yeah, they got 6,000 people stranded there. They said they were going to charter a plane. I think you better make that plural. But this is the same company now that had a ship out at sea that had to be drug in by tugboats, 3 weeks ago? I'm not real sure Carnival Cruise Line's one I want to rush out to the travel agent and book a cruise with.
Didn't Caribbean also have some problems? They also had a couple of ships that went down.
The Royal Caribbean?
Yeah, Royal Caribbean.
Norwegian was the one that had the ship that capsized in Italy.
Yeah.
In the Mediterranean.
Wasn't Caribbean?
I thought that was Norwegian.
We'll Google it and find out. But the fact is, here's what you have to wonder about. Are they turning these ships out so fast that they have defects? They're made over in the Netherlands or someplace. A lot of them made overseas in Europe. So why are there so many problems with these ships?
Well, here's
why. It's one after another, and apparently, I don't know if they're just used. I don't know what's happening. But obviously, if these were airplanes, they'd all be grounded.
Well, here's the reason. Airplanes, the FAA has such worldwide reaching effect. When they ground planes in the U.S., then everybody else starts listening, and they start grounding their airplanes. All these ships are registered in foreign countries. If they were registered in America, they'd have to meet guidelines that they say make it so expensive you wouldn't be able to operate effectively. So they register in countries that don't have very stringent guidelines on safety procedures and mechanical procedures, and so this happens frequently. And it's nothing to, I mean, I went on a cruise one time, buddy, a 7-day cruise to the Caribbean, where we weren't stranded at sea and we didn't go without food or anything, but there wasn't a bathroom that worked on the thing for the last 2 days we were on the boat.
Not a good thing.
And that's not good. But not a restroom worked. It was all every restroom you went into, everything was backed up, and so they said, "We'll give you a refund of your ticket and give you another cruise free." Like I was going to go on another cruise with them.
Yeah, I mean, it's really getting comical, and it's too bad because these people saved money and they took vacations and took time off, and now you know there's really no amount of money they can pay them is going to make up. They look forward to this and. This happens. It seems to be there's got to be a better way to govern this. Since they are registered to foreign governments, then they need to start having these ports. They need to say you can't dock your boat here if you haven't got your certificate that shows that you're up to speed on your electrical system or whatever it may be. There has to be a better job because it's getting to be ridiculous.
It is getting to be ridiculous.
Today, happy birthday. He would have been 134 years old, the smartest man who ever lived,
Albert Einstein.
Yes. 134. And, you know, if you start looking at all the things he did, you know, incredible. You forget about the fact that he won the Nobel Peace Prize in 1921 for physics. He was born in Germany and died in Princeton, New Jersey, 1955. His brain was removed for study and considered lost for many years. They've discovered images and specimens of Einstein's brain, which are housed in museums around the world, have been studied for clues. Einstein.
Isn't that sort of macabre?
It is, but I guess if you believe in cryonics, you know,
cryogenics,
yeah, you could come back and maybe you could put Einstein's brain in your mind.
One of the biggest urban legends ever is that Walt Disney's body is in a cryogenic storage at Disney World.
Well, Ted Williams supposedly is from the neck up, you know, his head. That's what they say.
Because his eye was so good.
I guess, his brain. It's just really at that point in time, I'm saying, I'm out. I don't want that deal. I start talking about that, I'm out. I'm sorry. I'm kidding. What's up with Matt Lauer? Well, I told you about earlier this week about the story that where he gave an interview to the Daily Beast, in which he explained his side of the story and talked about how he and Ann Curry had a good conversation meeting, and he said the chemistry was not good with Ann Curry and how he felt like it would be beneficial to the show because he felt the ratings were slipping if he had another partner. At some point, he and Katie Couric got together and talked. He tried to get Katie to come back to the show, and Curry's kind of left out there floating around. Then Ann Curry agrees to take another job with the NBC on covered news around the world. She agreed to it. They got together in the studio. They had a big thing planned one morning to say goodbye to Ann. And Ann began reading her statement, which they say she rewrote five times. And she began tearing up and gagging and whatever. It was a terribly sad scene. Everybody felt bad for her. She was a sympathetic figure. Matt Lauer trying to reach out to her, he says, reached over to go to give her a kiss on the cheek. She turned her head, and Matt ended up kissing her hair. And then he left, and then things got worse. And America blamed Matt Lauer to the point where, you know, the show's ratings were taking a dive. Now there's a front page story in the New York Times regarding what exactly happened and how bad is it for Matt. And I'll tell you about that in a moment. The fact that people on the staff think maybe it's too far gone. And I'll tell you about those other things coming up next right here on the Voice of Ocala. Plus, more than just a rumor. These are things that, we'll just see. We got information here, folks. We're going to share it with you right here on the program. Stay tuned to the Voice of Ocala.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, streaming live at WOCA.com. The source.
Hi, this is Buddy Martin. I want to tell you about a conversation I had recently with General Manager Pat Murray on the great family atmosphere at Country Club of Ocala.
It's a family first club. We have any number of different types of memberships, but obviously the one that attracts the greatest level of interest is our family. And the reason for that is we have a little something for everybody. I mean, we obviously have a world-class golf course. We have seven tennis courts here for all levels of tennis players. We have a junior Olympic size swimming pool. We have a fitness center that's second to none, and we have state-of-the-art equipment in our fitness center.
Country Club of Ocala, where the facilities are all a family would ever need. For more information, call today at 352-237-6644. That's 352-237-6644. Country Club of Ocala, proud sponsor of Monday's Gator Report and Gator Talk Thursday right here on The Source.
Hi, this is Buddy Martin. If you have an award or a trophy in your house, there's more than a good chance it came from BJ Trophies Gifts and Awards. At BJ Trophies, Floyd Hirschberger and his staff have a lot more than just trophies. Among the items they specialize in are donor recognition walls and trees, personalized or engraved gifts, cast bronze dedication plaques, wide format digital printing with posters, banners, and signs, and promotional products. Floyd is the official trophy and awards maker for the Voice of Ocala radio show and is North Central Florida's leader in custom recognition programs, corporate awards, industrial engraving, unique gifts, and advertising specialties. When Angie Lewis went shopping for something to award to the winners of her State Farm Good Neighbor Award, she shopped first at BJ Trophies Awards and Gifts. Check them out at 1735 Northeast Jacksonville Road on North Magnolia's Miracle Mile, or call them today at 352-732-2249. BJ Trophies Awards and Gifts. Trophies is just our middle name.
The difference at Ocala Eye is evident in everything we do for you. Whether it's our depth of expertise or a simple follow-up call after surgery, you can count on our 13 physicians and over 150 committed staff to look out for your eye health. Here's Al talking about his cataract surgery experience at Ocala Eye.
For some 25 years, I wore glasses. You know, that was always the biggest aggravation, was pushing those glasses around all the time. I got on the table and they did the procedure and took 10 minutes, 11 minutes. But when I went out, I was totally amazed. I could see clear. I had no glasses on. You know, it just changed the whole quality of my life at 68 years old. I mean, I see just like I did when I was 20.
To learn more about premium lens implants, visit ocalaeye.com. New patient appointments are now available, so call 888-202-7559 and see why more people are saying, Ocala Eye looks out for me.
Good credits, bad credits. It's none of our business because we're not an auto dealer. We're not a bank. We're not your mother. We're OcalaForSale.com, Marion County's marketplace for cars, trucks, and SUVs. We've got thousands of sellers standing by to take your call. No middleman. But hurry, don't walk, don't run. Just sit down and log on to OcalaForSale.com.
Prices and inventory change daily. Offered as an uncrewed dealer upcharge. Undercutting, rust proofing, factory surcharge, or delivery fee. See website for details.
Don't get caught without your daily source of senior deals. Pick up your copy of the Senior Voice newspaper. It's your source for schedule and events tailored to seniors with information you need, like a list of free events in the area. We even have Tom's Picks, a free referral for people who are looking for a company to do work for them. Tom's Picks will refer the company to you that fits your needs. And all we ask in return is that you tell them where you heard about them. For more information, call Tom's Picks, 352-804-1223. And pick up your copy of the Senior's Voice at most any business up and down the 200 corridor.
Now read Ocala Downtown Newspaper online.
The weather is brought to you by MyFWC.com. Life jackets save lives. Wear it, Florida. Will be a cool day out there despite plenty of sunshine. Highs from 63 to 68. Clear to partly cloudy, chilly tonight. Lows from 36 to 44. Cool tomorrow, mostly sunny, 69 to 73. Mostly sunny, nice. Saturday, 74 to 78. From the Florida Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Bill Dagher.
WOCA, Ocala.
This is Tom Schmitz live in the WOCA studios with this news break brought to you by Kinetic Motion Fitness. Ocala police are searching for a bank robber who stole an undisclosed amount of cash from Wells Fargo branch on College Road. The robber slipped the teller a note demanding cash but appeared unarmed. He left the building in a blue Chevy Impala. He was then pursued by police in a chase that reached speeds of 140 miles an hour, but the police abandoned the chase after the suspect crossed the Lake County line. If you have any information, call Crime Stoppers at 368-STOP. This news break was brought to you by Kinetic Motion Fitness, where the focus is on fun. Find them at kmfocala.com.
Turn it on up, pour a little Crown in a Dixie cup, get the party started. Girl, you make my speakers go boom, boom, dancing on the tailgate in the full moon. That kind of thing makes a man go
I don't know what morning show you guys listen to. I don't watch much morning TV now. I'm up, but occasionally when there's a news story, I flip it over. And I watch CNN occasionally, and I flip over to the networks, and if there's something significant. I used to watch the Today Show a good bit because they kept on top of news, and I think
it's so boring now.
And it's lost its edge. And, of course, if we talked about on this show the other day about how ABC is taking them over, especially Robin Roberts' story has seemed to capture the hearts of Americans. And so the Matt Lauer situation, Matt making $20 million a year, as I said before the break, he has become the person who's hated by many people because of how he supposedly pushed Ann Curry out. Now, Matt made his position clear on that. He says he didn't, and he said the networks say he didn't, but he did make it clear he didn't want to work with her as her partner. So, in a way, he did. So, that story came out, and now there's a story out, a front-page story in the New York Times this morning, reporting that the staffers at Today said that the damage done to Lara's reputation cannot be repaired, and that he won't sign another contract with the show. And his Q score, you guys know what a Q score is? That's how popular you are with it.
Right.
Widely seen as the top barometer in television popularity, has plummeted by more than 50% in 2 years. And it puts him behind George Stephanopoulos from ABC, who I thought really kind of was weak when he first started out, but has come on with the ensemble he's got there. That's the secret, I think, ABC's got. They got a good ensemble there. And as you pointed out, sometimes CBS with Charlie Rose and the gang, they're pretty good over there, too. So I watch them. But anyway, apparently the staff feels like that Curry thinks he was betrayed by him and says it's a pretty grim reaper story on the front page of Thursday's New York Times. More troubles for Matt Lauer. I can't feel too sorry for a guy making $20 million a year. But I do think Matt has lost his edge, and he got old in a hurry, and it does happen to us. That's how it goes sometimes. So, okay, in a moment we're going to play our interview from Christy Lovell when Angie Lewis had her on as her Good Neighbor Award, and she told a very touching and tender and, I think, valuable story to those of us who have a hard time with forgiveness, which I think is one of the classic stories about forgiveness. In just a moment, we're going to play that again for you because I think it's significant. If you've ever had an issue with forgiveness in your life, this is a really good one. And lately, I've heard several good stories like this, which I think are terrific. I think those stories need to be shared because we all have had issues where we've gotten crossways with people and we can't get past it. And even though you might want to, you get stuck. And something happens in your life to change that. Christy Lovell's story was quite remarkable. Meanwhile, more than just a rumor, new segment here on the program. What's up with CF's bid to become host of the state junior college basketball tournament? We have been somewhat involved in that. Tom Schmitz and I, we visited with the folks at CF, trying to promote that event and trying to encourage him and talking with Tim Ryan about it. It really started when Tim was on a story on a show with us, and he talked about how he had a dream was to win a championship on the floor of his home court. Of course, he won a championship. It was in Chipola. So what is going on? I haven't heard much about that, but a little birdie told me this morning some pretty good news there, guys. And this is number one item of more than just a rumor. It could well be happening. As a matter of fact, my little birdie says the coaches have all voted for the tournament to move to Ocala. But there's one more step, apparently, in the process, which has to be negotiated. And if that happens, could very well be that in 2014, that the state junior college basketball tournament will be played right here on the home court of the Patriots, which should be fitting because what a night they could have when they, you know, what next year is going to be special anyway because they're going to present the state championship trophy to them, and who knows what else? They're still playing. You know, if they get this hot streak going, they could get, you know, they could make some hay in this tournament. So, so that's the deal on that. That's number one. Number two, this is told to me by a friend. Did you know Tom Ingram and Ron Zook are opening a bar?
What?
At Eaton's Beach in Lake Ware. Now, that think that might be just a little off, but I kind of get the drift of what that is. And according to my sources, what's happening is there is a new facility being under construction at Eaton's Beach. If you don't know the lake where, you wouldn't know. It's over on the other side of the lake, beyond, on the other side of Gator Joe's. It's out toward, as you're heading, what is that road right there? Akawa. What is that road is there? It's over on the other side of the lake. It's a place where many families used to go way back in the day for picnics and stuff. A little more family-oriented in those days. It's been all torn down. They got a new facility going up there. There's a group of investors. They're going to have apparently a marina, and they're going to have a new restaurant and a lounge and whatever. And so what I'm told is that Mr. Zucca, Mr. Ingram are investors in the overall project. But we'll wait and ask Tom Ingram about it tomorrow on the show if he's around. So that's kind of a cool thing. Nice to go out there and have a nice meal at the lake, you know. And if you don't want to get a burger at Gator Joe's, which is pretty good, you can go around the other side and get yourself something else. So stuff happening. Looks like things are starting to happen all over the county. That's another good thing that could happen. So those are two things right there that are more than just a rumor.
Well, can I give you one of mine?
Sure.
I heard that somebody near to me is in the process of maybe adding or updating a very popular book about the University of Florida and its football program. The rumor I heard is that you, Buddy Martin, may be updating The Boys of Old Florida. Is there any truth to that rumor?
Well, I can go ahead and say yes to that right now. That will just kill that off. It's much more than a rumor. Is that it's another issue. I was contacted by the publisher. I don't have a lot of time to do all that right now.
I was
right
about
now.
To say, more stuff on Buddy.
Well, I basically got a co-author to help me out with it. And a person has helped me just basically helped me put... I've given them material, and we're going to get that together, and it'll be ready to be...
By Christmas, hopefully?
Oh, yeah. Skyhorse Publishing in New York is the one who contacted me about it. They bought the rights to the book. They want to update it. It ended after the first national championship. And it's a story of Florida football as told by people who played it and coached it.
It's a wonderful book.
Thank you.
And I'm not patting you on the back. It's really a good read.
Well, thank you. I appreciate it. It's labor of love, and it's really the history since 1950 of Florida football, an oral history, and it's not something you get in a book or a library, because this is all pretty much 90% original research and talking to players and coaches.
There's a section you talk to Charlie Pell's wife in the book.
Mm.
That's just an amazing insight into Coach Pell.
You know, it's the one person I couldn't interview. Because he was dead.
Right, I know.
But I had talked to Charlie a lot before and got to know him. And, of course, his wife was wonderful. She was terrific. So, anyway, so that's true. We'll
so,
give you more
so good.
About that.
So we, that's one
out of three.
We
know one out of three. Maybe tomorrow we'll know two out of three. So that Chrissy Lovell interview, it's quite long. We're going to do it at the top of the hour, JJ. I want to play this.
Well, the reason it's so long is... You needed to get the whole story in there.
Well, we'll have about 8 minutes in the first segment, and before Laurie comes in, we'll play that, because I think it's an important message.
It really was.
And could there be a nicer person in the world than Chrissy Lovell? I mean, she is just one heck of a lady.
Angie Lewis is pretty nice.
She is. They're both, I said, two of my favorite ladies in the whole world. Just walked
Don
in.
Lovell, another Lovell.
Another
very
Don.
Nice person.
Yeah. Yeah, and Sherry Lovell, my niece, is also quite a nice person. So you got a lot of them going
you
on.
You and
there.
Me? Not so much.
Not so much. Yeah. JJ, not so much. JJ, I don't know. JJ seems to be very popular with the ladies these days. I don't know.
The other LaSalva, Josh LaSalva, by the way.
I'm actually not doing very popular.
Giving Josh LaSalva a shout-out here.
Wait.
He is on the ball about this Francis Marion Military Academy Orienteering National Championship, and he'll have that tomorrow on his high school spotlight, and he is out beating the pavement, pounding the pavement, working that story.
Wait, you missed something JJ said. What was that? Repeat that.
I'm actually not very popular with the ladies
what?
Right now.
No, I'd heard that.
Hang on. Right, are you not listening to Dr. Buddy?
Sometimes a slump just happens, buddy.
No, it's a way, JJ. I have to coach you through this.
Buddy,
I know
even
I
good hitters go through slumps. Yes.
No.
All of Famers had slumps, buddy.
I know.
Come on. And I consider myself one.
You do, are?
Well,
he's a Hall of Famer.
But you and Tom got your own hall, so that's nice. Both of you elected yourselves to him, which is even better.
That's what's great about ours. You know, we don't have to worry about baseball writers.
My hall is about a foot long by about a foot wide.
All right, that's enough of that garbage. Let's take a break. We'll come back. We'll give you tweets and quotes next right here. Stay tuned to the Voice of Ocala.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, streaming live at WOCA.com. The source.
Relations got you down. Are you at your wit's end? Does the opposite sex just confuse you? Then I've got the solution for you, Dr. Buddy.
Well, let me just tell you what you slugs are doing wrong. Remember, dummy, it's about the chase and the romantic interludes, okay? Now, here's the difference. Instead of dinner and a movie, which seems obsolete these days, they have this random phone text, Facebook post, instant message, and quote-unquote non-dates. Traditional courtship, which is still what women want, guys. Picking up a telephone, asking someone on a date, maybe even going as far to pick them up in your car, requires courage, strategic planning, and a considerable investment in ego.
So now you know where to tune in to get all your relationship advice. It's the Dr. Buddy Show every Monday on the Voice of Ocala. You can succeed only on 96.3 FM, 1370 AM, The Source.
Hello, I'm Dawn Lovell, lead event designer and owner at Party Time Rentals. Have you ever wondered what it takes to make an event spectacular? Well, look no further. It's what we do every day. Whether you're hosting an intimate dinner for 10 or a gala for thousands, at Party Time Rentals, we find just the right style and elegance to make your event a success. Our extensive inventory of the finest in chandeliers, tents, crystal, china, and specialty items is featured in our fabulous showroom. Stop by and say hello. It's a great way to get ideas for an event and experience for yourself how you can make your party time special.
Party Time Rentals, located on Southwest 10th Street, just off Route 200 in Ocala, and off Southwest 34th Street in Gainesville. For more information, call 352-629-8858. That's 352-629-8858. The party begins at Party Time.
On the next AM Ocala Live, Robin and I have a first. We have a little bit of a mystery on our hands. We had a publicist call us and told us that a prominent philosopher and scientist wanted to be on our show, but did not want to reveal his name. So he's got a pen name, Dorian Alexander. Why we can't know his real name is a mystery. Dorian Alexander, or whoever he is, has written a book called Zarathustra Must Die. I guess we'll find out together.
Open for debate, where the listeners get to choose the topics.
And on Winging It, Brad Brosma and Josh Verdonk will tell you what it takes to become a pilot. They come in from Ocala Aviation Flight School.
John Sotomayor is the executive editor of Ocala Magazine. He will be on his show with his guests at Ocala Magazine Radio.
And then Carl F. Hobart will be on with us speaking about his book, Raising Global IQ.
Dr. Eugene Fisher has written a book called The Saint for Shalom, How Pope John Paul II Transformed Catholic-Jewish Relations.
And then Susan Benjamin Feingold is coming on, a psychologist specializing in antepartum and postpartum depression. Her book, Happy Endings, New Beginnings. All of that plus fun with Joe right here on The Source.
In Clark, we trust.
Hi, this is Clark Howard. Join me every weeknight at 6, right here on WOCA 1370, The Source.
Hi, I'm Fran Tarkenton, former NFL quarterback and member of the Hall of Fame. I know the importance of a game plan. A plan is the key to your success as well. Join me on Common Sense Retirement Planning Sunday at 10 a.m. on WOCA 1370 AM and 96.3 FM, The Source. And call us at 855-770-7926 for a free consultation with my financial professional in your area. See you on the radio 10 a.m. Sunday here on WOCA.
Hello? Can you hear me? Because if you can, then so can your customers. Radio works. Call today to advertise your business right here on WOCA 1370, The Source.
WOCA, keeping you in touch with Ocala.
Throwing little cherry bombs into my fire, good God Almighty. Girl, you make my speakers go boom, boom, dancing on the tailgate.
I come up at 4 o'clock after I'll play that Chrissy Lovell story of forgiveness, and Larry Martin Gregory joins us talking about health. Maybe a little showbiz thrown in there. Who knows what else. Meanwhile, time now for tweets and quotes. I could really dance to this song when I was a kid. Here we go. Number one.
You could dance to it now, buddy.
Probably could. I don't know who Sri Shinmoy is, but I like what he or she said. Judge nothing, you will be happy. Forgive me. Judge nothing, you will be happy. Forgive everything, you'll be happier. Love everything, you will be happiest. Then my man, Stephen Wright, who's always for a good chuckle, I just can't resist. I think my favorites are Stephen Wright, Will Rogers, Einstein, and Mark Twain. What do you guys think? Is that pretty good foursome?
That's pretty good foursome.
Yeah. Stephen Wright, you have to listen close to this guy. I took a course in speed waiting. Now I can wait for an hour in only 10 minutes. Guy's a whack job, and he's so funny.
He's the dude on the couch.
And finally, I don't know who Emo Phillips is. He a comedian?
Is he the dude on the couch?
He's the dude on the couch.
From Half Baked.
Yep.
No way. I had no idea that
that
was him.
He's so understated. Finally, Emo Phillips said, "You know what? You know what I hate? Indian givers." No, I take that back. Every now and then I get a little
That's hilarious to me that you just put Stephen Wright. That was him in the movie, JJ. So you really didn't know who Stephen...
I've seen a lot of his stuff, but I've never seen a stand-up.
He's dude on the couch.
Had absolutely zero lines in that movie, I think.
His name in the movie credits was...
Man on the couch.
Dude on the couch.
Thing about him is that everything he got or he lives on is a line. He lives on there. That's what he writes.
Right.
Fantastic lines. Nobody writes humor like Stephen Wright. He's absolutely not only one of the cleverest people, but one of the best writers I've ever read.
Oh, yeah. He's a very good writer.
Excellent, yes. So, anyway, so that's a little Stephen Wright. Again, we told you about our More Than Just a Rumor segment. We kicked that off. Coming up momentarily, Laurie Martin Gregory joins us. You know, you would put your food, junk food away, guys, because the cops are coming here soon. I don't want them to see you eating donuts and stuff like that and all those wings.
No bonbons.
You know, since I've been doing, or since, you know, when I started the Lori thing, like last year. Last February, I haven't really touched any of the donuts or nothing out there.
Can I tell you?
And there's fresh donuts almost daily.
Can I tell you? 276.
Well, we need to update you a little bit when Laurie gets in. Meanwhile, I'd get to the story, but I want to get to it sometime, a little bit of it, and the rest of it tomorrow. 10 businesses that benefit from war. You've heard the old phrase, guns and butter. Well, there's a number of these businesses that, when we go to war, they do quite well. We'll see if we can get to that next hour sometime. So stay tuned to the program. Call the voice of Ocala. We're 1 hour in, two to go, right here on
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, streaming live at WOCA.com, the source.
She grew up in the Indiana town, had a good-looking mom. She never was around, but she grew up tall and she grew up right with them Indiana boys on an Indiana night.
Hi, I'm Lisa Midget with Kinetic Motion Fitness, Ocala's premier small group and personal training fitness studio. Did you know you can achieve all your fitness goals, whether that's losing weight, getting fit, or training for a personal best, all with no membership fees? Have you ever been embarrassed or intimidated at a big gym because you're not a Greek god or a size zero supermodel? Have you ever felt like your gym would rather you not even show up? At KMF, we have a team approach that focuses on small classes and personal training, and you'll feel like family, not just another number. No more boring treadmills or endless reps. Our classes are fun, energetic, and get you the results you want. And I should know, with the help of our great trainers, I lost over 100 pounds in 8 jean sizes, and I did it using no heavy equipment and no magic pills, just fun and effective workouts. And yes, I did say fun. Come join us at KMF. Visit our website at kmfocala.com or like us on Facebook. Again, that was kmfocala.com.
Marshall Bank approval. Vehicle purchase process fixed credit allowance offers no combined.
Are you bored, tired, and disgusted with your old car?
Hey, this is Cupid, Chris Spears from Prestige Auto Sales. I want you to love your car, so trade in the old car you hate.
Even if you're still making payments. Even if you owe more than it's worth.
And I'll help you drive a nicer, newer car sooner than you ever thought possible. Plus, when you use your tax refund as a down payment, you'll get a lot nicer, newer car. So you can hook up with a car you love today.
Bad credit? Cupid got you down? Our For the People credit approval specialists are world-class matchmakers. They'll connect you with the lender most likely to approve your loan.
Hate your old car?
Dump it. And fall in love with a nicer, newer car today, even if you owe more than it's worth or still making payments. Plus, turn your tax refund into your down payment and save a lot on a car you'll love.
Hurry, this love fest ends when we match 57 people with a car of their dreams. I'm Chris Spears, and I'm a dealer for the people. Visit me in Ocala or Bellevue.
Online at PrestigeSaysYes.com.
Or call 694-1234. See you at Prestige.
If you need a sign or a banner for your yard or your business or your campaign, I'd recommend you go to Signs Unlimited at 318 South Magnolia in Ocala. Screen printing, embroidery, digital graphics. Do what I did when we needed signs for the Save the Marion Theater Group. Go see Vic Buttermore at Signs Unlimited if you want quality work with a fast turnaround from somebody who is deeply committed to his community and always ready to assist you. There's a reason Vic's slogan is, "It's our business to make your business better." Sign up for Signs Unlimited. Call 732-7341 today.
Hey, Larry, nice haircut.
Oh, thanks, Robin. Looks like you had something different done, too.
Yes, I did. Thanks for noticing. I went to Lupe at Merle Norman on the Boulevard for a fresh cut, some summer highlights, and a facial.
No kidding. That's who I go to. I didn't know she did all that.
She does coloring, waxing, styling, updos, microderms, and she does it all for prices that won't break the bank.
Sounds like you can take the whole family there.
As a matter of fact, I do.
Hi, this is Lupe. Let me be your personal stylist. To set up your appointment, call me today, 426-1229.
Right now, somewhere in the world, there is a bear waking up from a long winter's hibernation. Scientists are not 100% sure how a bear knows winter is over, but I think I may have an explanation. Here it is. Spring comes to Florida first, so Florida gardeners get that spring fever first and head over to Kenny's Place Nursery. They go to Kenny's Place for gazanias, impatiens, geraniums, and begonias, all for 99 cents each. They also head to Kenny's Place Nursery for pansies, selling for four for a dollar. Now, that is a honey of a deal. Well, the thought of the honey reminds those gardeners of the special role pollinators like bees have in the garden. Now, every bear knows that where there are bees, there is honey. So, their noses wiggle, their ears twitch, and boom, the bear wakes up. And all because of a great sale at Kenny's Place Nursery. Who knew? Kenny's Place Nursery is located at 7677 Southeast 41st Court in Ocala. Give them a call at 867-1213. It's a honey of a deal at Kenny's Place.
Every day we hear another story about innovation or about cutting-edge technology taking place right here in Ocala. The power plant, IHMC, Ocala 489. Did you know that important medical research is also being conducted here that may impact hundreds of thousands of people in the country someday? Maybe you've heard the name Renstar, but like so many others, perhaps you didn't realize that Renstar Medical Research is one of the top facilities of its kind anywhere in the U.S. There are important research studies being conducted by a highly qualified team of medical experts at Renstar, impacting decisions of major pharmaceutical companies and bringing new drugs to market. And you can be a part of these studies, as so many local people have done and are currently doing. Renstar has conducted more than 500 studies since its inception and would like to extend the opportunity to you to be a part of these cutting-edge programs. Call 877-629-5800 or 352-629-5800 if you'd like to know more. Renstar Medical Research, locally owned and operated in beautiful downtown Ocala. Renstar, seeking tomorrow's answers to the health questions of today.
You're listening to WOCA News Talk 1370, Ocala's source for what's happening in today's hottest, up-to-date news and topics.
A pocket knife has never brought down a commercial airliner. John Pistol is testifying to a Senate committee today on a plan to reverse the ban on the small knives starting next month. The Flight Attendants Union and a few carriers say that is a risk they don't want to take. The FDA is looking into a new group of diabetes drugs which may increase the risk of pancreatitis. The medications mimic a natural hormone which the body produces to break down sugar after a meal. It's an encouraging sign for job hunters. Fewer people are filing for unemployment. First-time claims dropped again last week, cutting the monthly average to a five-year low. A touchdown for female athletes in Philadelphia. Young ones, the Archbishop there will allow the Catholic Youth Sports League to field co-ed football teams. An 11-year-old named Caroline Plaw asked for the change, saying she'd been playing with the boys since kindergarten and was told now that she couldn't play with them. She thought that was wrong. This is ABC News.
At Advanced Auto Parts, we don't just sell parts. Oh, no. We get you the part you need. Lickety-split. Our knowledgeable team members will do the legwork, arm work, or torso work, whatever it takes, to make sure you don't just get a part, you get the right part.
fast. Plus, now, get up to $30 back by mail when you buy Wagner Thermo Quiet Brake Pads. Service is our best part at
Advance Auto Parts.
See store for details. Mail-in rebate. Void where prohibited.
Forward, so does the rest of the economy. CSX trains are the most cost-efficient way to move goods to market. CSX, how tomorrow moves.
I'm just sick of all the amateur stuff, you know? I mean, like, if I'm paying top dollar, I want a little production value, you know? Like some editing, transition, something, some music.
Don't worry, we didn't leave you.
He's gone. He's not gone. That's the whole point. He's never gone.
Our bosses say we gotta stay.
Check out the name tag. You're in my world now, Grandma.
Bow to your sensei. Bow to your sensei.
It's time for the second hour of The Voice of Ocala.
Hoo-ah!
You ever come across anything like time travel?
Come on, stick around. It's free.
If you win, you win. If you lose, you still win.
Hour to the program coming your way right now on The Voice of Ocala. Laurie Martin of Gregory joins us a little bit later in the program. Meanwhile, we couldn't get it in the first hour. We're going to do it now because it's, I think, an insignificant story. And we had Christy Lovell, local Ocala, wife of Bill Lovell. And she was Angie's special guest and her neighbor, good neighbor of the month this week. And we asked her to tell the story about forgiveness, and this is how it went. I want to get to this, too, and involves the church we both attend, and JJ's parents, too, Church of Hope. I experienced this without knowing this story. I just found out by going to church one day. And Christy's told this remarkable story about forgiveness and what she had to go through with and forgiveness and the toughest of circumstances. And it wound up becoming a wall. Christy, would you mind sharing that story with us just about what horrible thing in your life happened to you and what that did to your life and how you dealt with it?
Absolutely. Back when I was in college at the University of Florida, had a college roommate. Her name was Carla Larson, and Carla and I got to know each other very, very well throughout the years. If you know anything about architecture school, you spend many, many years in a design studio, a lot of long hours, and so you do grow very close with your friends in your design suite. Carla and I continued a friendship throughout the years because we were very unique being women in commercial construction years ago. And just absolutely maintained that friendship throughout the years because we needed each other. One day I was working at a project in Orlando and came home and just happened to turn on the news and I saw Carla's picture that she had gone missing. By this time, my children were, I believe, 7 and 3. She had started her family. And so I immediately called her husband to find out what was going on. And Carla had not, you know, gone back to the daycare to actually pick up her child. So I knew that something had gone wrong. And from that point on, that started the investigation to find her.
And you're thinking the worst at this point in time, or did you just feel like she was missing, or you knew her well enough to think something had to happen, right?
I knew her well enough to know that something had gone wrong, that this was just not like Carla to not be there to pick up her child from daycare. So once the investigation started, I believe it was just a couple days after that, that they had actually found her body. And what had happened was Carla had left the job site that she was working on. It was the Grand Floridian down at Disney that she was building. Had left the job site, gone to a Publix at noon, and was abducted. And, you know, it's just not what you would think of. Not the place or the time. A very well, you know, traveled area out in public. And So it was just a very, very tragic story.
She was murdered and buried right there near Publix, was it?
About two blocks back behind Publix. And if any of you have heard the name Carla Larson, it may ring a bell, because Sonia Larson was one of the victims of the Gainesville serial killer, Rawlings. Yeah. And so the tragedy, it's a double tragedy to this family, because they had suffered Sonia Larson's loss and then Carla Larson. It was Jim's sister and then his wife. So in a matter of a few years, he had lost both of these precious people in his lives, and very tragically.
And you're thinking, no way, no how ever could anything come out of this that would be any good.
Right.
Yeah, with your grief and your bitterness.
Right.
And so I'm going to put that on hold for a second. Take a quick break, come back. Let's tell the other, as Paul Harvey says, the rest of the story and where this got you in your life and how you're able to share this with other people and help them, which is the beautiful part of the story. Angie, the first part of the story that Chrissy told about the tragedy in her life and one of her best friends being murdered. Now here's the rest of the story, as Paul Harvey said. Chrissy, tell the rest of the story after this horrible thing happened and the years passed on.
Okay, so as the years went on, my friend Carla Larson, there were court proceedings and many, many trials throughout the years. And they ultimately did find the guy that did this. And his name was John Huggins. And so we went through several trials and appeals. And it was such a public murder that...
You were at the trials somehow, weren't you?
I was at the trials. Mm-hmm. There was one in Jacksonville, Tampa. It occurred in Orlando, but it had been moved around to all these big cities. And so throughout the years of sitting through the trials and... seeing the evidence, seeing pictures, watching the little baby girl grow up. Jim and Carla at the time had a 13-month-old baby. And so she has grown up, lovingly with her dad, but without her mom. And so throughout the years, and
were you getting bitter at that point in time?
I really was. This name, John Huggins, I had just grown to really hate him.
And I don't see see that you could hate anybody, but I can understand if you did, why you would.
Sitting there, too.
Yeah, that's even hard for me to say, but I really, really did. And I really struggled with that feeling because I didn't like it. And I just really wrestled with this. Why could such a wonderful person be taken from us and so tragically?
So how much time roll forward until you had this moment that just shook you to the foundation and you were able to go forward and share the story with other people?
Okay. Several years later, my husband and I were serving in the nursery at our church, and we had the two-year-olds and happened to look up, and this lady was coming down the hallway with a two-year-old, and we had gotten to know most of the children in the nursery because we had served there for many years. And this was a newcomer, and so of course we reached out as much as we could, and as she walked down the hallway, she just kind of captured my attention, and this little baby boy that she was carrying was just absolutely beautiful, had the most beautiful brown eyes, very, very captivating. And she walked up to the door, and I was greeting her, and as she was signing in, of course I asked, "What's his name?" And, of course, his name was John Huggins.
No relation.
No relation, but it was a name that I had just really, really grown to dislike over the years.
Now I'm going to have to move you forward to get it in real fast.
Okay.
As a result of that, something happened to you, and you began to realize that you had to have forgiveness in your life, correct?
Right, right.
And without going into the depths of that, you decided one day to get up in front of the church and tell the story.
Right.
And then did what? We had about a minute to tell that story at the wall.
Well, we did this wall, a forgiveness wall, and it says up top, Christ forgives me, so I forgive. And it was just a wonderful time that we had in our church where I was able to share the story of forgiveness, and people in the congregation could go up and sign their name on the wall, and basically just releasing these things that were bothering them and the burden of unforgiveness that we carry.
And Angie, that wall now is on all this writing on it. It's still there. They plan to keep it for a long time. And people still go up there and write things on it.
Sharpie markers. It's permanent.
Yeah. I mean, what a way to take a horrible, tragic story and turn it around to a story.
Another reason why Chrissy Lovell is an amazing person right there.
You are exactly right.
We're out of time, but guys, thank you so much for coming, Chrissy, and thanks for being the person you are in our community. And go back home and tell Bill how lucky he is, will you?
Thank you. I will do that.
Right, Angie Lewis, story of forgiveness. That's a good one. All right, we'll take a quick break, and we'll come back. Laurie Martin Gregory will be here. I'll tell you the story. What does a Speaker of the House do when he's invited to the installation of the Pope? What should he do? Well, I'll tell you what John Boehner did, and we'll talk about whether it was the right thing and the wrong thing. Coming up next, right here on The Voice of Ocala.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, streaming live at WOCA.com. The source.
Every day we hear another story about innovation or about cutting-edge technology taking place right here in Ocala. The power plant, IHMC, Ocala 489. Did you know that important medical research is also being conducted here that may impact hundreds of thousands of people in the country someday? Maybe you've heard the name Renstar, but like so many others, perhaps you didn't realize that Renstar Medical Research is one of the top facilities of its kind anywhere in the U.S. There are important research studies being conducted by a highly qualified team of medical experts at Renstar, impacting decisions of major pharmaceutical companies and bringing new drugs to market. And you can be a part of these studies, as so many local people have done and are currently doing. Renstar has conducted more than 500 studies since its inception and would like to extend the opportunity to you to be a part of these cutting-edge programs. Call 877-629-5800 or 352-629-5800 if you'd like to know more. Renstar Medical Research, locally owned and operated in beautiful downtown Ocala. Renstar, seeking tomorrow's answers to the health questions of today.
Recently, I had a great conversation with General Manager Pat Murray on the special events at Country Club of Ocala.
We have a lot of events, special events here that are geared towards the family. Easter comes to mind. We have an Easter bunny who hops around on the driving range, and we usually hide somewhere in a bit of 3,000 eggs and turn them loose and let them go harvest the eggs. We have a great family celebration here on the 4th of July where it's a traditional cookout, if you will, and as the sun goes down, the driving range becomes alive with probably one of the better fireworks displays in the area. Breakfast with Santa is a big deal.
Country Club of Ocala, where the Easter Bunny, Santa, and all the children, large and small, are a big deal on every special occasion. For more information, call 352-237-6644. That's 352-237-6644. Country Club of Ocala, proud sponsor of the Monday Gator Report, right here on The Source.
Hi, I'm Tom Ingram, CEO of Gateway Bank, inviting you to drop by our main office on Silver Springs Boulevard every Friday from 3 to 6 p.m. for the Community Gazette, a three-hour show focusing on our favorite community to live and work, Ocala Marion County. Come join us with the voice of Ocala, Buddy Martin, in the new old-fashioned bank radio studio as we discuss a variety of interesting topics on the Community Gazette on WOCA The Source.
Ocala Radio, WOCA.
Hi, this is Brad, one of the hosts of Winging It here on WOCA every Friday at 9 a.m. I want to take a moment to talk about a serious issue regarding aviation. In the next 5 years, the aviation industry is projected to have a shortage of commercial pilots, in part due to the lack of new pilots starting their flight training now. A pilot needs 2 to 3 years to get through their training and to build up enough flight time to be able to be hired. Now is the time to start training. Ocala Flying Club has started a scholarship for the youth of Marion County ages 17 to 24. The club will donate up to $4,000 towards a private pilot's license. This license will help get the student on their way to obtain their commercial pilot license. Now, of course, the student does not have to have aspirations of becoming a commercial pilot. If they simply have a desire to obtain their private pilot's license so they may enjoy the adventures of flying, they may also apply for the scholarship. If this sounds like something you would be interested in, or if you know someone that would be, please contact me, Brad, or Ron at Ocala Aviation Services. 861-7484. That's 861-7484.
Listen, you two work all week. So what are you doing Saturday? Yes, this Saturday. You two are going to work in the yard or maybe go to a car show. You may even start the honey-do list. Great. That fills your Saturday. What about Saturday night? How about this Saturday night, March 16th? Dinner and a dance for two for $25. Sounds good? The music is by Southern Express Big Band. Yes, the Southern Express Big Band, with the sounds you can dance to or just relax and listen after a great dinner. So get dressed nice and go to the Silver Spring Shores Presbyterian Church, 674 Silver Road. Call them at 352-687-1119 for your reservations. Hey, you two worked hard. Treat yourselves. Call 352-687-1119. Dinner and dance to the sounds of the Southern Express Big Band. Doors open at 5 p.m. Go! Enjoy! For all in love can conquer hate. You know we've got to find a way to bring some love and get here today.
Oh. All right, welcome back. Laurie Martin Gregory in the house. Just a moment, she'll join us. I want to tell you about a story. John Boehner gets criticized a lot, and sometimes justifiably so. But here's one where I got to say, there's no way you can win this deal. He was invited as the Speaker of the House to the installation of Pope Francis. And he says he wanted to go, but he said it was impossible with his duties, including the budget debate and hosting the Irish Prime Minister at the Capitol. I'm sure he put the Irish Prime Minister because it's predominantly Catholic, you know, right in there. So apparently Joe Biden, who is Roman Catholic, is going to lead the delegation. So I'm thinking, I guess the Vice President's got time, but the Speaker doesn't. But Boehner said that after Obama spoke to the Republicans on Wednesday that the president invited Boehner, as Catholic, to accompany Biden, but Boehner says he's grateful, but he's going to turn him down. All right, now, what's the thought on this? And just larger, you can weigh in too, but what do you do here in this situation? On one point, I think, in that situation, I say he needs to go. Get over and get back. After all, it's a huge deal, and it would seem like, since he's Catholic, right?
Right. Yes.
Yeah, so it would seem like that he'd feel an obligation to do that. On the other hand, you know that some Democrats would trounce him for going out of town, out of the state, although the vice president probably got no problem. So I say whatever he does, he gets criticized.
You say he loses either way.
Yeah, so what do you guys think? Should he go or should he go or not go?
You got to go. And yeah, it's not like they're getting much done in Washington anyways.
Good point.
So, geez, I mean, what is it, a one-day trip?
Well, probably a little more because you got time changes and stuff like that, so a day and a half, 2 days.
The Roman Catholic in the room says that's what the vice president's supposed to do. He's the guy that goes out and goes to ribbon cuttings and stuff for the president, and he's a Roman Catholic. John Boehner is in charge of the House, and the House is busy right now trying to get over themselves and figure out how to deal and compromise with Democrats, and that's his job he was elected for. He was not elected because he was a Roman Catholic that needs to run off to Italy to go to a papal installation. That's what the vice president's job is. Good for John Boehner saying no.
Okay. Laura, you can join in the conversation if you like.
He's going straight to hell.
Is and that because he's a Republican?
That's exactly what I'm saying. And he'll meet almost 95% of all Democrats that are serving or ever have served. So let's all have a good time together.
Let's not turn it into that. That was not the point. It wasn't a political statement. She was kidding, of course.
She was not kidding.
I don't think you turned down the Pope, whether you're Catholic or not. That's a little scary.
It's interesting that that Obama, who's not Catholic, was the one who invited him.
New Pope's supposed to be a laid-back, cool guy, man. He doesn't wear the cape anymore.
Got rid of the cape?
Yeah,
still a superhero, though.
He wears just normal Pope clothes. He went, paid his own bill at the hotel himself.
Stop it.
Swear.
Didn't take the limo.
Right.
Declined the demo. Rode with the Cardinals on the bus.
Apparently, he's a San Lorenzo Football Club supporter, which is a big Argentinian.
He's
a San Lorenzo Football supporter,
oh, yeah,
which is a big Argentinian club. So, he's a man of the people.
Yeah.
Which is what he was billed as. He was a cardinal to people. He would ride it. The bus in Argentina, he would ride the bus to and from work every day.
Is he doing his own tweets?
I don't
know. That's what I want to know.
There is a Twitter account for him, by the way.
You know what? So first thing he needs to address, and this is coming from a Roman Catholic under the age of 50, first thing he needs to address is we need to do something about changing the rules on priests. Okay? It's about time we got to the 21st century and priests are able to do what every other man in the world is supposed to be able to do, lay with women like it says in the Bible.
Do you know the first pope was actually married?
Yeah, it was Peter.
Peter the Second.
Yeah.
He was married.
It was Peter, one of the disciples.
And supposedly the change had to do with the not wanting priests to leave their inheritance to children, but instead leaving it to the church.
It was all a money
all
issue.
Money.
Isn't it still all money issue?
Well, I didn't say it, but...
It's about time we took the way the Episcopalians did it, by the way, which is exactly... Episcopalians are Catholic, but their priests can marry, and divorce isn't looked on near as bad as Catholic, because Henry VIII wanted a divorce, and the Pope wouldn't give him one, so he created his own church. It's about time we understood that they probably got it right. A lot of little boys wouldn't have been, you know, traumatized and everything if we'd have turned this into what it should be years ago.
That's not necessarily true, by the way. There are pedophiles who are married.
No, I understand that, but not near as many pedophiles as there are in the Catholic Church would have been there.
Maybe.
Well, I would just say, bring it back to healthy living, which is why I'm here. In Ayurvedic medicine, there's a saying, never suppress a natural urge.
Exactly.
And that means, let's just say in general, that there is, you know, within a healthy, respectful arena, of course, but in general, you know, there's a lot of repressed sexuality that, you know, look, it's free, it's a free country, it's a free world, you can choose how you want to live your life, and obviously, you know, men and women who've signed up to be part of the priesthood or part of a convent, they know the deal, and that's what they've chosen, but it does seem like it's relatively outdated and
it's very archaic.
Kind of unnecessary in this day and age, so it'll be interesting to see what they do. They have a huge image problem. The Catholic Church in general. They need to hire a spin
master. They need to hire Lord Martin.
Some marketing and PR desperately.
Let me jump in here. First of all, don't get deluded into thinking that this Pope's going to make massive changes.
No, it's not going to happen.
He's 76 years old.
Right. Yeah.
He's old school in many ways, although progressive. I noticed in the interview Anderson Cooper had in St. Peter's Square, about with women, many of them, young women, obviously in their 30s, are saying, we're so hopeful that we're going to be able to have a female priest, and we're going to... And mm-hmm. that will happen someday,
but not
going to happen
in this papal.
Look, John Paul II, people thought that you wouldn't have females that could give that could work as lay priest giving Eucharist out, and John Paul II made that happen. And
well, that's not the same thing, though. It's not anywhere close to the same as big an issue.
But to a Roman Catholic, giving of the Eucharist is the most important thing that happens in
you
the Mass.
You think that is every bit as big as a female pope, a female priest?
It's huge. For a female in the Catholic religion to be a lay priest and hand you the body of Christ and the blood of Christ,
right.
In our religion,
minister.
The Eucharist
but
celebration.
You think
is,
that's as big as being a priest?
It's pretty big. Important-wise, it's the most important thing that a priest does.
Well, they don't need to have priests then.
The most important thing a priest does is the Eucharist during a Mass. That's the most important. With turning the bread and wine into the body.
But how does that relate to a female becoming a priest? I mean, the highest...
But they already...
What's the highest job in the church?
But they already hand out the Eucharist.
Yeah?
This is a female can tell you, this is the body of Christ.
Yeah?
And give it to you. Yeah. That to
it's
a Catholic...
It's called a Eucharistic minister.
That to a Catholic...
Mm-hmm. I know. I've actually taken communion at a Catholic church.
That's one of the seven sacraments. If a woman could do one of the seven sacraments, she could run the finances of a church. She could run the Catholic school that may be attached to a church. She could do the Knights of Columbus day-to-day operations of a church. If you trust a woman to give the body of Christ to you...
Yeah, but it's not going
to
happen. This pope,
of course, she can do all those. There's
pope
no question
Francis
about it.
Is conservative. He's anti-gay. He's anti-gay adoption. He calls it child abuse.
Yeah, it is.
So don't dilute. You know, I agree with what you're saying. There's no way this is not going to be some massive change.
Pope John Paul II. Pope John Paul II made it where women could give the Eucharist. That's why I don't understand why women can't be priests, because the most important thing that takes place at a Catholic Mass is the giving of the body of Christ.
Can't hear confession.
And women can do it.
Hey, no, dude, it's your religion, not mine.
I know.
It's your deal. You have to write him a letter.
I don't know if I want a woman priest hearing my confessions.
But they can give...
I'm saying, why wouldn't they be able to give
confessions?
But you're
missing the point. Listen,
what am I missing?
Women can give the body of Christ to you.
So
if they're trusted with that, which is one of the seven
Larry
sacraments,
says, don't tell me that.
But it's not.
Tell your Pope.
It's
I don't know.
I mean, but right, that's an even more tangled point.
Exactly.
So you know, it's all messed up. They need some help. The Catholic Church needs some reform.
Let me get back to what the original premise is about here.
Don't forget, it's still growing.
Let me get back to the original premise of what the Pope's job is and his mentality and outlook, and whether or not you repress urges and so on. So that is all part of all religion, repressing urges. But let me finish. It's part of it. And the second thing is, his job is to lay the guidelines out there. That's what they do. It isn't in regard to anybody's particular philosophy. It's basically the rules of living.
But he doesn't even do that much. Isn't he kind of like the Queen of England?
No, he sets the...
No.
His policies.
He's
Congress.
Like he's like the President of the United States.
Do what he wants to.
Well,
for the Catholic religion... The
President of the United States can't do what he wants to.
But that's the thing. He's more like a monarch than that, but monarch in the old sense, where he tells the cardinals what they need to come up with.
He can
yay or nay it and make them go back and come up with new guidelines.
That's 5 o'clock, not 4:30.
No, the Pope has... power autonomy over the entire church.
All right, so anyway, to get move on to this other topic, just to finish this thought off, Boehner.
Who has the worst spray tan in Congress, by the way.
It's a little orange.
Oh.
I think Boehner tried to do the right thing. I hope it wasn't totally politically motivated. That would be what would bother me. It's like, look at me, I'm going to do this.
Of course it is.
But I'm just saying. But I do understand it's a tough choice. No matter what he would have done, he'd be
criticized
for it.
It's a lose-lose.
Yeah, you cannot make the right decision. Maybe that's why the president invited him. I don't know.
Maybe that was a political decision.
Yeah, probably.
That was it. So, all right, we'll take a break, come back. Laurie's got, what you got for us, Laurie?
Oh, I've got some healthy living. I've got if you want.
Yeah,
I mean, you know my stance on antibiotics.
We've been talking about it for 2 days, saying you're going to talk about it.
Well, I didn't hear you. Sorry.
Read your emails.
I read the emails to ZPAC ? I mean, I can talk about it if you want, but what I have on tap is talking about digestive health and what you can do to really make it optimal, and it's not as hard as you think, and also a couple of pop culture tidbits.
And I have a list here of people who somebody rated the food companies, and you'd be surprised some of the ones who did pretty well on this list. I know you want to know.
Yeah,
I
saw that list. I don't agree with it.
Well, it's just telling you what
Lori's going to say. Who, in fact, was spending the money to compile the list?
That's right. Who hired the PR agency to put the list
out?
The
guy who owns Microsoft. That's who we are. So,
there you go. Right. Bill Gates, the guy who's funding vaccines all around the world. And Monsanto, by the way.
Well,
he's funding Monsanto for GMO foods.
Vaccines might be a little different story. But anyway, the food companies, it's a nonprofit. You always complained about commercial companies. This is a nonprofit was funded partially by him.
Scam.
So
we got to go.
We'll talk about it when we come back.
All right. We'll come back and discuss that and more right here on the Voice of Ocala.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, streaming live at WOCA.com. The source.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And so is State Farm agent Angie Lewis, working hard to serve her community as a citizen and insurance agent. Angie wants to help you as you adjust your insurance needs to your life. From everything to helping educate your teen driver to protecting your family against everyday risk. She wants to change the way you perceive insurance by developing relationships with her clients, which is why Angie and her staff are proud to be a part of so many good causes in Ocala. In turn, she has chosen to single out those who step up as leaders. Each month on the Voice of Ocala, Angie spotlights a good neighbor, saluting those who give exceptional service or do random acts of kindness to others. For this, Angie was written up in State Farm's National Magazine. Angie also supports local businesses with a regular Biz Buzz. The Angie Lewis State Farm Agency is located at 1122 Northeast 36th Avenue, where visitors are always welcome and the coffee pot is always on. Call your good neighbor's State Farm agent today, Angie Lewis, at 294-2444.
I'm Dawn Lovell, lead event designer and owner at Party Time Rentals. Have you ever wondered what it takes to make an event spectacular? Well, look no further. It's what we do every day. Whether you're hosting an intimate dinner for 10 or a gala for thousands, at Party Time Rentals, we find just the right style and elegance to make your event a success. Our extensive inventory of the finest in chandeliers, tents, crystal, china, and specialty items is featured in our fabulous showroom. Stop by and say hello. It's a great way to get ideas for an event and experience for yourself how you can make your party time special.
Party Time Rentals, located on Southwest 10th Street, just off Route 200 in Ocala, and off Southwest 34th Street in Gainesville. For more information, call 352-629-8858. That's 352-629-8858. The party begins at Party Time.
On the next AM Ocala Live, Robin and I have a first. We have a little bit of a mystery on our hands. We had a publicist call us and told us that a prominent philosopher and scientist wanted to be on our show, but did not want to reveal his name. So he's got a pen name, Dorian Alexander. Mm-hmm. Why we can't know his real name is a mystery. Dorian Alexander, or whoever he is, has written a book called Zarathustra Must Die. I guess we'll find out together.
Open for a debate where the listeners get to choose the topics.
And on Winging It, Brad Broersma and Josh Verdonk will tell you what it takes to become a pilot. They come in from Ocala Aviation Flight School.
John Sotomayor is the executive editor of Ocala Magazine. He will be on his show with his guests at Ocala Magazine Radio.
And then Carl F. Hobart will be on with us speaking about his book, Raising Global IQ.
Dr. Eugene Fisher has written a book called The Saint for Shalom, How Pope John Paul II Transformed Catholic-Jewish Relations.
And then Susan Benjamin Feingold is coming on, a psychologist specializing in antepartum and postpartum depression. Her book, Happy Endings, New Beginnings. All of that plus Fun with Joe right here on The Source.
Phoenix Promotional Solutions, your company supplier of banners, digital decals, yard signs, and magnetic signs. Where you give them approved artwork by noon, the next day by 4 p.m., you pick up your banners, digital decals, yard signs, and magnetic signs. Phoenix Promotional Solutions, 368-2404. That's 368-2404. Don't forget, they do vehicle wraps also. Phoenix Promotional Solutions, 368-2404.
Every day we hear another story about innovation or about cutting-edge technology taking place right here in Ocala. The power plant, IHMC, Ocala 489. Did you know that important medical research is also being conducted here that may impact hundreds of thousands of people in the country someday? Maybe you've heard the name Renstar, but like so many others, perhaps you didn't realize that Renstar Medical Research is one of the top facilities of its kind anywhere in the U.S. There are important research studies being conducted by a highly qualified team of medical experts at Renstar, impacting decisions of major pharmaceutical companies and bringing new drugs to market. And you can be a part of these studies, as so many local people have done and are currently doing. Renstar has conducted more than 500 studies since its inception and would like to extend the opportunity to you to be a part of these cutting-edge programs. Call 877-629-5800 or 352-629-5800 if you'd like to know more. Renstar Medical Research, locally owned and operated in beautiful downtown Ocala. Renstar, seeking tomorrow's answers to the health questions of today.
Welcome back to the program. Time to talk a little healthy living with Laurie Martin Gregory. What you got, Laurie?
Well, I'm going to talk about the importance of cultivating and nurturing your digestive fire. It's not something we think about very often. It's not something we talk about very often. But it is something that affects our overall health and is something that after you turn 30, if you don't think about it, you will definitely start to experience symptoms that you don't like, and it will continue as you age. So if you want to stay healthy, you really need to start thinking about your tummy and your gut as a part of your well-being that needs to be taken care of. You know, we have plumbing in our house. We take care of our plumbing. You're supposed to, actually, if you talk to a plumber, they'll tell you.
Put the Riddix, bacteria.
You're supposed to take care of your, every 2 years, you're supposed to snake your drains. You're supposed to make sure that it all stays running smoothly. It doesn't build up any residue. And we don't think about that with our bodies. There's a lot of other cultures that do. For example, in Japan, which is the highest consumer of sushi in the world, America's slowly catching up to that just by volume. But, you know, they eat a lot of sushi, a lot of raw fish, but for 2 weeks, once a year, Japanese people will do a cleanse where they eat nothing but rice, because they know that when you eat raw fish that you will pick up some hitchhikers, that your digestion can very easily get imbalanced, and that your digestive fire can start to get low. When your digestive fire gets low, whatever you eat is not going to get burned up. If it doesn't get burned up, your digestion starts to get sluggish. And, you know, one of the ways you'll know if you have sluggish digestion, right around 3:30, you start to get tired. If that happens to you and you find yourself hitting that coffee machine or going for that candy bar or trying to get a pick-me-up at 3:30, then your digestion has become sluggish, because that's when your lunch, whatever you've eaten for lunch, is now processing its way through your digestive tract. And if your digestion is sluggish, it will take your energy, it'll take all the energy that you have, it will sap you just to get your food through. So you want to think about ways to take care of your digestion, to keep your fire strong, so that your body stays optimally healthy. And that is the foundation for a healthy immune system right there. Important thing. So, you know, once a year, maybe even twice a year, in the spring right now is a great time to do it. It's a good time to take a little break from things like alcohol, to take a break from heavy foods, from sugars, from complex carbs. Try to eat whole foods, fruits and vegetables, fresh, organic if you can, organic or at least meats that don't have hormones, steroids, antibiotics, all the additives that are toxic for your system. Sip hot water and lemon. If you're a caffeine junkie, give it up for 90 days. I'm doing one right now. I don't do caffeine, but I'm giving up my red wine for 90 days. I'm giving up any kind of, you know, substance that's just not healthy for me, to give my gut a chance to reboot.
90 days without red wine.
It's amazing how much better you feel. I'm on my second week now. My husband's doing it with me. It's certainly easier if you do it with somebody. We calculated out 90 days. The end of our 90 days will be our anniversary. So then we can go out for dinner.
Gary's giving up red wine.
My
too.
French husband has given up red wine for 90 days.
That's a commitment.
That's right. It was actually his idea, believe it or not. But it's, you know, it's amazing how easily your system will recover, how quickly it will recover, and how easily you can reboot. And you will, if you haven't done this before and you're over 40 or you're over 50 or even 60, then you definitely want to take on some support with some herbs. There are a zillion products out there. I don't make a penny off this. I'm not endorsed by any product companies. But a real simple good one is called Paragon. You can get it at Mother Earth or Earth Origins or any health food store. You can get it online. Vitacost is a great discount vitamin house. Sometimes 35-40% off. And take some herbs to help really cleanse out your system. You'll be amazed.
Think JJ gave up scotch, bourbon, and gin, didn't you, JJ?
For 10 minutes.
Pretty sure. Didn't you?
No.
I believe you did, didn't you?
Recently?
Yeah, scotch, bourbon, and gin, right?
Never. Never. Yeah, you're right.
JJ's 23.
I only drink whiskey.
But he's 23. I mean, you got to factor in his age.
Let me ask this question. You said a 90-day cleanse.
I help you out, JJ.
You said a 90-day cleanse.
I know.
Yeah.
But even a 10-day or a 14-day cleanse.
No. The body rebuilds itself in 90 days. In 90 days, you can have a completely new heart. You can have a completely new liver. You can have a
I understand, but what I'm saying is the 10-day or the 14 days no good to do?
It's not going to give you the deep toxic cleanse that 90 days will. I mean, if you can't give up something for 90 days, you've got a problem. And you need to look at that.
Well,
it's not that
long.
I've
tried to give up the radio program for 90 days, but still have Buddy pay me, and he won't let me do that.
Good luck. When you figure that out, then, you can phone it in after you figure that out.
Now, let me ask you, because I've been with Lisa Midget at KMF Fitness doing... Mm-hmm.
You're looking good, by the way.
Doing workout regimen, change my diet.
Are you spray tanning?
No, I'm not.
He's looking tan, right?
No.
You're looking tan.
Golf.
Yeah. Okay.
I'm doing exercising, and we go out to Jervy Gant exercise.
Tan salon.
And
Jervy Gant Tan Salon.
You said if your gut's not good or
Tim and
you're having digestive issues, it saps your energy.
Yes.
I was always tired about 2:30, 3 o'clock in the afternoon.
You hit
always.
That wall.
It happened every day.
Mm-hmm.
Now that I'm working out every day,
right?
I don't hit that wall anymore. Is that because working out.
Movement will move your digestion. It's going to help. But in the Ayurvedic tradition, Agni, A-G-N-I, which is digestive fire, actually needs to be cultivated. That means you need to eat foods that are alkaline. You have to be mindful. You have to have a mind-body connection that helps you be aware of your body's ability to burn up food and absorb it. So remember, if you don't burn up food, you're not going to absorb it, and then you're not going to efficiently eliminate waste. So movement does help, but by definition, the standard
pound cake every day is still
the standard American diet, and the initials are SAD, S-A-D, and it really is sad. The standard American diet is all foods that are congestive, that are it's like putting glue and concrete in your gut. So after 20, 30 years of eating a standard American diet, movement will help. But you will find that as you then enter your 30s, 40s, 50s, you're going to start having some real problems.
Well, I've had to adjust my food. I mean, I'm not eating pizza anymore.
You went on that great diet of cleanse of that Five Guys Burger cleanse, right?
Yeah, I'm not eating Taco Bell anymore. I don't eat hamburgers.
Congratulations.
JJ just said when you came in, since I've talked to Laurie, I don't eat that junk food like I used to.
Out in the lobby.
Word.
Yeah, and he said donuts and stuff. He said he didn't eat them at all.
Lori, a guest of the show yesterday said I looked skinny and buff.
Oh, dude.
Drinking red wine.
So,
I didn't know.
Is it your mom was here? No. I didn't know. You are looking good. I mean, the thing that's most important about what you did at such a young age, JJ, is you became aware. It's awareness, and everybody is different. You know, you can take one concept, but if you apply it across the general population, it's not going to work for everybody. Right. The point is to be aware of it. Now, you said, Tom, I became aware that I was sluggish and tired around 2:33. Do you know, a lot of us are out there walking around. We're not aware of this. We just get real cranky and grouchy at 2:33, and we become nasty. We don't even know it's because we don't really feel good and we're tired.
I became aware of it once I started working out. It disappeared, and I was like, oh, that's a big change.
Right.
But something else I've done is, this week I've been bad because Carswell Ponder brought some cookies that are just fabulous.
And by the way, who do you bring the cookies to?
Me.
Nice.
That's changed now. So it's yesterday. Yeah, you made such a big deal. For a while, it was both of us.
You made such a big deal about it yesterday. Now it's me.
Carswell.
Except for the cookies at Carswell, by the way, great cookies.
I'm sure. Did Charlotte?
I wouldn't know. I didn't have it.
Did Charlotte make them?
No, Carswell makes them.
Oh, he makes them?
He has his own label on them.
Oh, my gosh.
But
I love that. You didn't have any?
Shots with me. Those were my cookies, too. I didn't have a single. He didn't give me a chance to give them.
I've learned.
He sort of offered me a cookies. Oh. I said, I thought you said he brought us some cookies.
Mm.
Well, I know. Well,
I've learned back to, knowledge about food.
Notice, JJ, how he just avoids that, right?
I've learned through that I'm a sweet tooth guy. I got to have
me
something
too.
Sweet. I love sweets.
Yeah, sure.
But, pears and bananas and oranges in moderation and white grapes
have become sweet.
Are just as sweet.
They are.
As a chocolate bar.
So are carrots.
Yeah,
sauteed carrots and beets.
As a chocolate bar.
That's right. But you become desensitized. If you eat a standard American diet, which is sad, then you will lose it's just like any other drug or any other substance, which is what I say about coffee all the time. You're going to need more to get the same sensation. So, if you eat chocolate bars every day, an orange isn't going to taste sweet because your taste buds become dull. And you can tell if you look in the mirror in the morning and there's like a waxy coating on your tongue, then you've got some built-up ama, which is undigested food. That's undigested food bits that are hanging out in your gut.
Gross.
And, then dump some coffee in there, and you're just making more acid, which is the perfect environment for bacteria, viruses, parasites to hang out.
She looked right at Buddy when she's talking about the coffee.
I'm looking at you.
Do you drink coffee, Tom?
No, I don't like it. I drink coffee maybe once a month. I'll have a cup of coffee at Starbucks.
Right.
Because
decaf?
No.
Why not? There's really good decaf out there now.
I have the caramel mocha just because I like the sweet.
Oh, okay.
It's not really what I have. Has coffee in it, but it's more like hot chocolate than it is coffee.
Right.
Yeah. So.
All right, we take a break, come back. I do want you to comment on Z-Packs because it was a big story that came out this week regarding the fact they found Z-Packs were not just damaging to your your system, but also could cause heart problems too. So
I've been saying the same thing for years about it, but I will say it again.
I'm validating what you said.
No, I'm happy to repeat it. I just wish I had something new to offer, but it's the same old sad story. And then I also want to talk a little bit about pop culture. I've got a new favorite show.
All right, we'll have to make it quick. We'll have four ones we get back. So stay tuned to the Voice of Ocala.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, streaming live at WOCA.com. The source.
Hi, this is Buddy Martin. If you have an award or a trophy in your house, there's more than a good chance it came from BJ Trophies Gifts and Awards. At BJ Trophies, Floyd Hirschberger and his staff have a lot more than just trophies. Among the items they specialize in are donor recognition walls and trees, personalized or engraved gifts, cast bronze dedication plaques, wide format digital printing with posters, banners, and signs, and promotional products. Floyd is the official trophy and awards maker for the Voice of Ocala radio show and is North Central Florida leader in custom recognition programs, corporate awards, industrial engraving, unique gifts, and advertising specialties. When Angie Lewis went shopping for something to award to the winners of her State Farm Good Neighbor Award, she shopped first at BJ Trophies Awards and Gifts. Check them out at 1735 Northeast Jacksonville Road on North Magnolia's Miracle Mile, or call them today at 352-732-2249. BJ Trophies Awards and Gifts. Trophies is just our middle name.
Relations got you down? Are you at your wit's end? Does the opposite sex just confuse you? Then I've got the solution for you, Dr. Buddy.
Well, let me just tell you what you slugs are doing wrong. Remember, dummy, it's about the chase and the romantic interludes, okay? Now, here's the difference. Instead of dinner and a movie, which seems obsolete these days, they have this random phone text, Facebook post, instant message, and quote-unquote non-dates. Traditional courtship, which is still what women want, guys. Picking up a telephone, asking someone on a date, maybe even going as far to pick them up in your car, requires courage, strategic planning, and a considerable investment in ego.
So now you know where to tune in to get all your relationship advice. It's the Dr. Buddy Show every Monday on the Voice of Ocala. You can succeed only on 96.3 FM, 1370 AM, The Source.
Here's what you may have missed on the John Tesh Radio Show.
Married men are more likely to keep up with routine doctor's visits than bachelors. Their cancer was detected earlier, so they were 35% more likely to survive. The longer we commute, the more stress we have in our bodies, the higher our body mass index, and the more strain it puts on our relationships. People learn more effectively when they break up their lessons over several short sessions rather than one long cramming marathon.
Intelligence for your life on the John Tesh Radio Show. Don't miss this stuff.
Right now, somewhere in the world, there is a bear waking up from a long winter's hibernation. Scientists are not 100% sure how a bear knows winter is over, but I think I may have an explanation. Here it is. Spring comes to Florida first, so Florida gardeners get that spring fever first and head over to Kenny's Place Nursery. They go to Kenny's Place for gazanias, impatiens, geraniums, and begonias, all for 99 cents each. They also head to Kenny's Place Nursery for pansies, selling for four for a dollar. Now, that is a honey of a deal. Well, the thought of the honey reminds those gardeners of the special role pollinators like bees have in the garden. Now, every bear knows that where there are bees, there is honey. So, their noses wiggle, their ears twitch, and boom, the bear wakes up. And all because of a great sale at Kenny's Place Nursery. Who knew? Kenny's Place Nursery is located at 7677 Southeast 41st Court in Ocala. Give them a call at 867-1213. It's a honey of a deal at Kenny's Place.
What's up with you this weekend?
Just doing my taxes.
Doing your taxes? Go to Liberty Tax. Do you want your money fast or do you want to wait?
Fast, I guess.
That's right. And where do you get America's fastest refunds?
Liberty Tax Service.
Let Liberty Tax show you the freedom.
Find us at LibertyTax.com or call 866-871-1040 today to find a location near you. That's 866-871-1040. That's 866-871-1040.
Liberty Tax Service.
All right, final minutes. Larry Martin, Gregory, let's address the first real quick. Just give me 45 seconds on Z-Pak. You've been such a staunch advocate of not using antibiotics on this program, and now the story comes out saying that possibly and it's on the nightly news now. It's not like it's not just like a medical story.
It's not a holistic those weirdo holistic.
Well, it's
people.
In the mainstream media. Yeah. I mean, that's how people evaluate things, and they're saying not only is it not good for your immune system, but it could cause you heart damage over Z-Pak. Now that's a little different than some of the other. It's a very popular antibiotic. I know people take a lot of those, take those things about tons.
It becomes our default reaction to getting sick. We go to the doctor and ask for a Z-Pak. I'm only talking about this because I used to be one of those people in my early 30s. Every 3 months, I would get sick, and I would go get antibiotics and come home and take them. And it was just a vicious cycle that went on and on and on. And I finally got sick of it, and I thought, this can't be normal. You know, why am I living like this? This doesn't seem like the way we're supposed to live. And I never really got better. You know, I was always run down. I would see pictures of myself and think, oh, I look so pasty white, and I've got dark circles under my eyes, and what is going on? And the reality is that we come from a legacy in our culture of over-prescribing antibiotics, overusing antibiotics in both our food production, our meat production, and in our health care, and it's catching up to us. So the best thing you can do is what I'm saying: clean out your gut, take probiotics, start looking into culturing, making your own home cultures. It's really simple to do. You can get raw milk and culture it with good bacteria. It's phenomenal. I'm really incredibly impressed with what you're able to do if you're willing to look into it.
All right, got a minute. We're going to finish up with another topic real quick.
Oh, well, pop culture. New favorite show. It's kind of harsh, but it's just a parody on politics in general. So I've really been enjoying Veep, which is the new Julia Louis-Dreyfus series that's on HBO. It is so ridiculous and such a spoof on politics in general. And I'm sure that a lot of what they act in these different scenes is what happens in Washington. So it's, if you're a political fan at all and you want to have a good laugh, Veep is great. And you know, now when you get HBO, it's so great that maybe I'm the last person to know this, that they keep all the series. Did you know this, JJ?
Yeah,
it's on demand.
It's all on demand. Right. You can go back and watch from the beginning. Right. So I did go back and watch Girls because Lena Dunham watched the Golden Globe. Really harsh. First series was very well written. Was surprised to find out the gal that plays Marnie is actually Brian Williams' daughter from the NBC Nightly News.
It was on CBS this morning, had a whole feature on.
You know, I was
thinking, she's making millions, by the way.
Oh, of course. Yeah. And she was
not her, but the one who was.
Oh, Lena Dunham, of course. But second season, not so interesting. But you know, think back, like in the 70s and 80s when Dan Rather was anchoring the CBS News. Can you imagine if he had a daughter in a racy show on TV? It would not work.
No,
I think he would have been fired.
Maybe. Never
this
know.
Is interesting how our times have changed.
Times have changed.
Mindy Project, she was actually eye patch on Mindy Project, which got renewed for a second season, JJ. Thank you very much. Going to see Oz this weekend. Looking forward to seeing my boy James Franco, who I studied acting with in California.
At the Marion Theater.
Don't think it's going to be there after Thursday, actually, my friend, unfortunately.
Wow.
Marion Theater not been giving times on past Thursdays. It's been hard to get times for some reason. But March is the month that all the studios dump their dogs. It's the worst time to see movies, so just hang in there and it'll get better.
All right, Larry Martin Gregory joins us every Thursday to talk health, sometimes religion, and sometimes politics.
Always food, though. Always
politics,
food.
Sometimes food.
Always food.
All the above. We'll talk to you next week, Larry. Thank you very much. Stay tuned for the Voice of Ocala Buddy Sports page. Who is Harris English, and why is he important? Well, I'll tell you next. Stay tuned to Buddy Sports page right here on
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, streaming live at WOCA.com. The Source.
Hey, this is Cupid, Chris Spears from Prestige Auto Sales. I want you to love your car, so trade in the old car you hate.
Even if you're still making payments. Even if you owe more than it's worth.
And I'll help you drive a nicer, newer car sooner than you ever thought possible. Plus, when you use your tax refund as a down payment, you'll get a lot nicer, newer car. So so you can hook up with a car you love today.
Bad credit? Cupid got you down? Our For the People credit approval specialists are world-class matchmakers. They'll connect you with the lender most likely to approve your loan.
Hate your old car?
Dump it and fall in love with a nicer, newer car today, even if you owe more than it's worth or still making payments. Plus, turn your tax refund into your down payment and save a lot on a car you'll love.
Hurry, this love fest ends when we match 57 people with a car of their dreams. I'm Chris Spears, and I'm a dealer for the people. Visit me in Ocala or Bellevue.
Online at PrestigeSaysYes.com.
Or call 694-1234. See you at Prestige.
Hi, I'm Lisa Midget with Kinetic Motion Fitness, Ocala's premier small group and personal training fitness studio. Did you know you can achieve all your fitness goals? Whether that's losing weight, getting fit, or training for a personal best, all with no membership fees? Have you ever been embarrassed or intimidated at a big gym because you're not a Greek god or a size zero supermodel? Have you ever felt like your gym would rather you not even show up? At KMF, we have a team approach that focuses on small classes and personal training, and you'll feel like family, not just another number. No more boring treadmills or endless reps. Our classes are fun, energetic, and get you the results you want. And I should know, with the help of our great trainers, I lost over 100 pounds in 8 jean sizes, and I did it using no heavy equipment and no magic pills, just fun and effective workouts. And yes, I did say fun. Come join us at KMF. Visit our website at kmfocala.com or like us on Facebook. Again, that was kmfocala.com.
Hi, I'm Tom Ingram, CEO of Gateway Bank, inviting you to drop by our main office on Silver Springs Boulevard every Friday from 3 to 6 p.m. for the Community Gazette, a three-hour show focusing on our favorite community to live and work, Ocala Marion County. Come join us with the voice of Ocala, Buddy Martin, in the new old-fashioned bank radio studio as we discuss a variety of interesting topics on the Community Gazette on WOCA The Source.
Mark your calendars for Saturday, April 6th for the Francis Marion Military Academy Spring Fling at the Ocala Shrine Club on Maricamp Road. Join the first annual Swamp Fox Chili Cook-Off and Classic Car Show. Take a chance on winning one of 5 different late model vehicles for the unbelievably low price of just $20 per ticket. Only 5,000 tickets will be sold. The proceeds benefit the Francis Marion Military Academy. Businesses, organizations, and talented individuals are invited to show off their cooking skills and to compete for the best tasting chili. Go to Swamp Fox events.com for the registration directions to the Shrine Club, Car Show, Chili Cook-Off. Join our sponsors in supporting the Academy. Remember, that's Saturday, April 6th for the Francis Marion Military Academy Spring Fling at the Ocala Shrine Club on Maricamp Road. The first annual Swamp Fox Chili Cook-Off and Classic Car Show. For more information, call Charlie at 843-7790. That's 843-7790. 843-7790. Or visit swampfoxevents.com.
That fabulous spring garden show just rolls along at Bob Wine's Camellia Gardens, and one of this week's hottest specials is citrus trees. Bob has just received a truckload of citrus. They're available at super low prices. Take your pick. A huge selection of budded and blooming citrus, ready for planting, just $59.99 each. But Bob's spring garden price is even better than that. Buy 2 for $99. That's right, less than $50 each when you buy a pair of these wonderful citrus trees at Bob Wine's. And if you're really cramped for space, check out the new dwarf citrus trees. You can plant them in a pot or on a tiny piece of dirt. They're super low priced now at Bob Wine's, and don't forget those spring veggies. Just about any veggie you want, just $2.29 in 4 packs, and those popular 4-inch herbs, also $2.29 a pack. It's held over another week. The huge spring garden show at Bob Wine's Camellia Garden, Southeast 38th Street, Ocala. Open daily till 4. Don't miss it.
Hi, I'm Tom Ingram, CEO of Gateway Bank, inviting you to drop by our main office on Silver Springs Boulevard every Friday from 3 to 6 p.m. for the Community Gazette, a three-hour show focusing on our favorite community to live and work, Ocala Marion County. Come join us with the voice of Ocala, Buddy Martin, in the new old-fashioned bank radio studio as we discuss a variety of interesting topics on the Community Gazette on WOCA The Source.
You're listening to WOCA News Talk 1370, Ocala's source for what's happening in today's hottest, up-to-date news and topics.
always this way. A generation ago in most families, dad worked and mom stayed home. Now the Pew Research Center says the two-career couple is the norm. Most share the load, splitting housework and childcare, and almost all say they wish they had more time. Find you're watching the financial markets a lot more these days. It's easy when you're making money, and if you have a 401k, you probably are. The Dow hit another all-time high today. That mid-afternoon cup of coffee or green tea may do more than just perk you up. A Japanese study says it could lower your risk of heart disease and stroke by up to 30%. You may need to drink at least 2 cups of green tea a day, or 1 cup of coffee, though, to reap the benefits. The boss may not expect as much of you and your coworkers the next few weeks. Outplacement firm Challenger Gray and Christmas says productivity tends to slide when the NCAA basketball tournament's on, and some of those games are played during work hours. This is ABC News.
Here we have a rare treat. The keeper of the forest, as some have coined her. Built to carry heavy loads, long distances, using minimal natural resources. Her coat of iron and steel keeps her safe. You can just feel the motherly instinct she has for her surroundings.
Sometimes the best things for nature come in unexpected forms. CSX trains move 1 ton of freight nearly 500 miles on a single gallon of fuel. CSX, how tomorrow moves.
Safe Light Repair, Safe Light Replace.
Julian with Safe Light Auto Glass.
So you think all auto glass companies are the same? Only America's largest gives you the reliability of this Safe Light advantage. It's what makes us different. With over 5,000 mobile glass shops in all 50 states, so we're always nearby. And the only national lifetime guarantee, keeping you covered wherever you are. Make the safe choice.
Just ask your insurance company for Safe Light or call 800-800-2727 or go to safelight.com.
I'm a shot. 30 seconds. I'm on right now. I don't believe you.
Okay, okay. Enough kidding around.
Ho, 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 ho. Ho, ho, ho.
And now it's time for the Buddy Martin Sports Page.
He actually had me stay here last night in his gym.
It's like I don't belong here.
Let's go talk to a couple of guys that never gamble.
Oh, see, I made Lewis a bet here. Lewis bet me that we couldn't both get rich and put you on the poor house at the same time. He didn't think we could do it.
Gambling is illegal at Bushwood, sir, and I never slice.
And now, here's Buddy.
Hi, welcome, Buddy Sports Page, on a Thursday, and close to the weekend. Thursday means they're playing golf, and down on the West Coast, they're playing something called the Tampa Bay Championships in the Copperhead at Innisbrook Resort in Palm Harbor. Played that golf course a few times. Hard. I thought it was. Of course, they're all hard for me, but today, a guy named Harris English leads 5-under through 13. Teddy Potter, Mr. Goff, not doing so well. Nice shot, 73 today. He's tied for 95th. I can see that tomorrow. I can see why that wouldn't be a great golf course for Teddy. No, it really doesn't set up for his game at all. So, anyway, so that's what's happening in golf this weekend. Basketball underway. Let's get a quick update, guys. Who's going to play Florida tomorrow in Atlanta in the 1 o'clock game? I guess the 1 or 2 o'clock game. That game played today, LSU-Georgia. What you got there?
Right, LSU won 68-63 today, so they will play Florida. Miami ends up playing Boston College after they had a freshman score 41 points. They beat Georgia Tech pretty decisively by 20. And also in the ACC, NC State beat Virginia Tech. Sort of big news, Oklahoma is one of those fringe teams. They lost their first game, which is huge. To Iowa State in the Big East, always one of the exciting tournaments. Syracuse won by 3 against Pitt. They will play Georgetown, who also won today.
Apparently, Mississippi State is struggling against Tennessee. Tennessee with a 13-point lead with 9 minutes to go in that game in the SEC. So we'll keep you updated as we go right along. Other headlines in sports news today, JJ?
All right, well, last night the Hawks beat the Lakers. And with about 4 seconds left, Kobe pulled up for a shot to try to tie the game. When he came down, Dante Jones's foot was under his, He had a bad sprain, and of course Kobe says it was a dirty play. But now Dante Jones is coming out saying, I didn't intentionally try to do that. They sort of had a bad history. He tripped Kobe before. Who really knows what
actually
happened?
There were two other incidents. Once he tripped, once he pushed him. I know we all saw the play. I think we kind of agreed. We didn't think it was a little snug. It was a little snuggy, but he was playing pretty good D, and just because Kobe jumped on his foot, that doesn't seem to be a dirty play to me. He did come at him a little bit when he released the ball, but that's the guy's job. I've seen blatant fouls on three-point plays or guys been knocked into the stands and never called.
You can see a lot of times when people do put their foot down and intentionally try to mess them up. Kobe had that happen early in his career with Jalen Rose, did it like 2000, I think. And I think Kobe even said something about, he Jalen Rose'd me.
Well, Jalen Rose this morning, when they asked Jalen Rose about that on the 10 o'clock Sports Center this morning, Jalen Rose says, let me explain something. I know it's an unwritten rule in the NBA not to get into a jumper's or shooter's space once they've left the ground to take a shot.
Right.
But I learned from playing on hard concrete courts and street ball in the city of Detroit that every now and then, if you need the best player not to be in the game, you get up underneath him.
Right.
So Jalen Rose admitted there was times he got up underneath players on purpose to try to sprain their ankle or something.
So I think it's, to me that'd just be a basketball play. And
it's like a hard slide.
Certainly not anything like when he tripped him.
What got me was, while I didn't think it was a dirty play, I think the NBA referees missed an obvious foul. Kobe was fouled on that shot for not having the opportunity to come back down on the ground.
Maybe. I thought Kobe was really lighting it up, too. I saw the highlights. He was really making some big threes there at the end and brought it back and chance to win the game. Anyway, moving on. Other news, JJ in the NFL.
Steven Jackson signed with the Falcons right after they released Michael Turner.
How old is Steven Jackson? 32?
Steven Jackson is 30.
We'll check it out.
Where do you see that at? 29-year-old.
29, that's all? Yes. Seems like he's been in the league a long time.
And a really old guy, my boy Ed Reed, is talking to the Houston Texans, buddy. Yeah. So it looks like Baltimore's a completely different team.
And the Miami Heat became only the fourth team in NBA history to have a 20-game winning streak.
Yeah, but all along the lines of the NFL, Matt Cassel to the Vikings.
Right. And he'll be competing for the starting position with
a guy that...
What's his name?
Christian Ponder.
I was thinking Sexton for some reason. It's a crappy
Seminole
Florida
fans
State quarterback.
Yeah, so you Miami fans have a mental block.
Chris Ricks?
A guy that Percy Harvin said, even though he threw the ball to Percy constantly, said was not a quality NFL quarterback. Mm-hmm. Maybe Percy still had a little Florida in him, not wanting to say the Florida State guy was any good.
You know, you can't blame him. All right, so that's what's happening in the news. Coming up here in a little bit, we've got a guy who's going to be on the show with us again. Last year he was on this show. He won the Gator Nationals in Gainesville, and his category. So Morgan Lucas will join us, and we'll catch up with him and see what he's
going
on.
Avid football fan, by the way.
Yes, and by the way, Lucas, as in Lucas Oil. Maybe you heard of that little stadium in Indianapolis there that has that name.
Remember that story you told us last year, JJ, about how we asked you about the models you see in the parts store where you crank them and it shows you oil versus how Lucas Oil moves? He says, yeah, don't remind me. I sat in the garage many a night making those for my dad.
This is racing, by the way, so let's not assume that he's still sponsored by Lucas Oil.
His name is Lucas.
Right. And but he was sponsored by Lucas Oil.
By the way. He's still sponsored by Lucas Oil.
Yeah, he'll be sponsored by Lucas Oil as he races.
Okay, he's like Paul Menard. Paul Menard and NASCAR will always be sponsored by Menards.
By the way, NASCAR,
that's his family's business.
NASCAR is not the same thing as drag racing.
No, by the way, speaking of NASCAR, the list of top paid drivers is out. And as you might expect, Dale Earnhardt Jr.
Why don't you hold off and tell us after the break?
Oh, I can do that.
That would have been called a tease.
I can do that. I
don't tell him, just actually tell him.
Tell you how it's amazing how much NASCAR drivers make it. I was amazed at the numbers.
All right. Also coming up 5:30, big money at the OBS sale. Another big sale, $1.8 million for a Colt, which ties the record. Michael Compton joins us to tell us about that. Also, Derby prep races coming up. And we'll top it off with Franz Beard, who will be on today, talking about Florida's game tomorrow against LSU, as it turns out now in the brackets. We'll take a break. We'll return in just a couple of seconds here with a guy who's going to be running. How fast up there? 200 miles an hour?
No, buddy.
No?
300 plus.
300 plus, yeah. Of course, he doesn't go a mile. But
no, it goes 1,000 yards.
Yeah, but he does fly. Morgan Lucas, after this timeout on the program, call Buddy Sports Page.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, streaming live at WOCA.com, the source.
Hi, this is Tom Schmitz, the host of Buddy's Saturday Sports Page on WOCA. The Saturday Sports Page is your weekend destination for everything sports, from NASCAR to golf, baseball to boxing, and of course, the best, most comprehensive football coverage on the radio. Also, you don't want to miss my weekly Are You Kidding Me rant? So join me and JJ LaSalva every Saturday morning at 10 a.m. for Buddy's Saturday Sports Page on WOCA, the source.
Every day we hear another story about innovation or about cutting-edge technology taking place right here in Ocala. The power plant, IHMC, Ocala 489. Did you know that important medical research is also being conducted here that may impact hundreds of thousands of people in the country someday? Maybe you've heard the name Renstar, but like so many others, perhaps you didn't realize that Renstar Medical Research is one of the top facilities of its kind anywhere in the U.S. There are important research studies being conducted by a highly qualified team of medical experts at Renstar, impacting decisions of major pharmaceutical companies and bringing new drugs to market. And you can be a part of these studies, as so many local people have done and are currently doing. Renstar has conducted more than 500 studies since its inception and would like to extend the opportunity to you to be a part of these cutting-edge programs. Call 877-629-5800 or 352-629-5800 if you'd like to know more. Renstar Medical Research, locally owned and operated in beautiful downtown Ocala. Renstar, seeking tomorrow's answers to the health questions of today.
Hello, I'm Dawn Lovell, lead event designer and owner at Party Time Rentals. Have you ever wondered what it takes to make an event spectacular? Well, look no further. It's what we do every day, whether you're hosting an intimate dinner for 10 or a gala for thousands. At Party Time Rentals, we find just the right style and elegance to make your event a success. Our extensive inventory of the finest in chandeliers, tents, crystal, china, and specialty items is featured in our fabulous showroom. Stop by and say hello. It's a great way to get ideas for an event and experience for yourself how you can make your party time special.
Party Time Rentals, located on Southwest 10th Street, just off Route 200 in Ocala, and off Southwest 34th Street in Gainesville. For more information, call 352-629-8858. That's 352-629-8858. The party begins at Party Time.
Alice?
Yes, George?
Did you know I'm a truck driver now?
What?
I called Devon Self Storage at 873-0777 and John and Mike now have a moving truck.
Are you cleaning out the garage?
Well, I do have time because Devon Self Storage is open late and they're right across from Hobby Lobby on 200.
You better call them first and reserve the truck.
Why?
So I'll know when there's room for the car.
Yes, Alice, yes.
Look who just walked in the room, Joe Wiesner from What's Up Ocala. Hey, Joe, I'm looking for something to do this weekend. You got any ideas?
Absolutely. Check out our event calendar online at www.whatsupocala.com, and there is plenty of events there for you. Daily news updates to event reviews and magazine articles.
Really?
We've organized it all in one place online for you to cut through all of the hassle of finding something to do this weekend. We have a daily event calendar, a bi-monthly magazine, and we also do daily news articles.
All right, Joe, that's perfect. Thanks so much.
Yeah, whatsupocala.com.
Every day we hear another story about innovation or about cutting-edge technology taking place right here in Ocala. The power plant, IHMC, Ocala 489. Did you know that important medical research is also being conducted here that may impact hundreds of thousands of people in the country someday? Maybe you've heard the name Renstar, but like so many others, perhaps you didn't realize that Renstar Medical Research is one of the top facilities of its kind anywhere in the U.S. There are important research studies being conducted by a highly qualified team of medical experts at Renstar, impacting decisions of major pharmaceutical companies and bringing new drugs to market. And you can be a part of these studies, as so many local people have done and are currently doing. Renstar has conducted more than 500 studies since its inception and would like to extend the opportunity to you to be a part of these cutting-edge programs.
Call 877-629-5800 or 352-629-5800 if you'd like to know more. Renstar Medical Research, locally owned and operated in beautiful downtown Ocala. Renstar, seeking tomorrow's answers to the health questions of today.
Just to follow up on yesterday's conversation about Wes Welker and clarify my comments. I don't want to sound like an idiot, although sometimes I do. We talked about how would he do in Denver. And my comment was he'll do really well because he's playing with the ultimate checkdown quarterback. And that quite often he is the third receiver because he's a slot receiver. The quarterbacks like to throw to their wide receivers, obviously, first, but they're not open that much. Now, Welker had these enormous stats, which J.G. pointed out, rightly so, yesterday. Did he have 115 catches, J.G.?
Last year?
A couple of years, I think.
Anyway, the last few years, he's been killing it, stats-wise.
Anyway, so he's had, obviously, great numbers, and he flourished in that system. With Tom Brady, obviously.
108 catches, 1,300 yards last year.
So, obviously, and my point is, I guess I didn't make it very well, is that he's such a weapon when he catches the ball. He got that great quickness and elusiveness that he can break it. He also drops the ball sometimes, as we saw in the Super Bowl, remember. But a great pickup. I heard it today. I heard a conversation on ESPN about that. I forgot it was Teddy Broussard. Who was it said it?
Broussard's basketball.
I mean, not the
Teddy
Bruschi. Bruschi, or he said it, or somebody else did. Christian Ferrari, didn't he play for him? Christian Ferrari is who it was. Talking about the fact that when they take somebody away, like Welker, they give Tom Brady back something back.
Amendola. They signed yesterday might be better than Wes Welker.
Really?
Yeah, but he's just been hidden away in St. Louis, and he got hurt last year to end the season soon. But I'm telling you, watch out for this kid.
Well, he didn't. I mean, it wasn't
Danny
like he
Amendola.
Didn't. They didn't give him chump change. Offer him chump change.
No.
What was it? $10 million they offered him. 2 years.
I think it wasn't nearly as much as Welker would have wanted, but yeah.
But he got offered more by. But the point was made by Bruschi. And others that the big thing was, it was about respect. He's never been given the respect in New England. And I think that's what he wanted. He wanted a little bit of love there from the Patriots, and he didn't get it. So I know that our intern, Sean, is a big NFL fan and not a big fan. Pick that microphone up over there, Sean. And I know that you suffer through, like JJ, with the Buffalo Bills. And were you a Patriot hater?
I will always be a Patriot hater.
And a Jets hater, by the way, and
Dolphins.
I tolerate the Jets a little more than the Patriots. And the Dolphins definitely. The Dolphins definitely have been a pain in the butt of Bills fans for a very long time.
You know what's faint? If you go back in history, way back when, the team that ruled New England and the Northeast, that area. Buffalo. The New York Giants.
Wow.
I'm talking pre-Buffalo and pre-New England Patriots.
Mm-hmm.
That the Giants were enormously popular in New England. And I found that out in my early days in New York, how big they were.
When did New England start playing professionally?
Well, the U.S., it would be in the days of the AFL. The Boston Patriots. So it would have been 60s. I forgot what year the AFL started. I have to look it up.
The AFC East is making some awesome moves, though, this offseason. Dolphins special.
They're really smart guys. They're really smart GMs. They're sitting back and laying in the wings because there's deals to be had out there. Because these rosters are getting really crunched because of money. And, there'll be some opportunities, I'll put it that way.
There are tons of really good free agents out there.
Speaking of opportunities, I believe we have an opportunity to speak to the defending top fuel champion from the Gator Nationals, Morgan Lucas. Morgan, thanks so much for joining us today.
Oh, thanks for having me. I really appreciate it.
Well, last year this time, we Buddy Martin, my boss, who is the host of the show, and myself, Tom Schmitz, we had you on, and we were talking about what your chances were of winning the Gator Nationals. We said you'd win it. Lo and behold, on a Monday after the rain out on Sunday, you won the thing. So can we take credit for that, please?
Oh, please do. Please do, because we get our good luck from a lot of strange places, and sometimes not so strange, but it's just any luck is good luck.
Well, with the weather cooling off today, what's the forecast looking for? What are you looking for? Is the track much different with the cooler weather? Is it going to heat back up by the weekend?
Well, you know, the extended forecast is saying that it's going to get up towards the high 70s, low 80s, but that's not going to be as probably a good of track conditions as we had last year, but I think it's still going to be really good. The car has just overall picked up performance, and NHRA has done a really good job with the prep overall, and it's just helped add to the performance levels just increasing. And when you look at the first two races of the year, the numbers everybody's putting down, they're really impressive. So I think it should be better here than it has been at the first two races.
What does it mean to Morgan Lucas to now have on his resume Gator Nationals top fuel champion?
You know, I've always dreamt about winning this race. And last year we knew we had a good running car, and we knew we had the potential to win. But something just clicked last year. And for me, just to be able to see that trophy at home, and to have the memories from winning here and knowing all of the people that have won here in the past, it's a huge honor.
Well, now, the racing, the show is this weekend. When is Top Fuel qualifying? When does that take place?
Well, we start running, I want to say, right around 2 o'clock tomorrow afternoon. We make two runs tomorrow, and then we'll start running on Saturday at about 12. We'll make two runs Saturday as well, and then we start running eliminations at 11 o'clock on Sunday morning.
Morgan, Buddy Martin here. Good luck to you on this weekend. How often do you run? When you practice, how many times do you run your car this week?
If all goes well and you win the race, you'll make as many as 8 runs.
Okay.
And that's 4 qualifying runs and 4 elimination rounds.
Now, before you got here, obviously it's a different service, but you ran the car where?
We just got done running in Phoenix, or basically just South Phoenix and Chandler, Arizona, and in Pomona, California the week before that.
Can you go by times?
I see what you're saying. Yeah, no, we ran 376 at Pomona. We ran just like some 376 in testing in such in Phoenix. So the runs that we were making here last year at 374, those are really impressive runs. And at that point, not a lot of people had even ran that quick. A lot of people picked it up towards the end of the year. But I think if it cools off enough and the track can hold it, we should be able to see it at minimum of 372.
So it's really all about the service and the weather, but by the same token, the machine has to be stroking it right, too. So,
And you know, this is a special treat because you never know what rule changes will might happen. This is probably one of the faster racetracks that we're going to be on. I mean, people could be seeing speeds of 330 to 332 miles an hour, I would guess. And that's pretty cool to see that in 1,000 feet. It's amazing inside the car, but it's a spectacle to be seen as well.
How special was that run you made last year on Saturday when you ran the 374? Because I was at the track. I was trackside. I had spoken with you earlier that day, and I was trackside. And just the way the crowd just erupted with energy when that posted up on the scoreboard, what was that feeling like for you when you looked up and saw it on the board?
To be honest with you, I was kind of in disbelief. Before last year started, I had never ran anything quicker than a 3.8-second run. So to dip down that far and to be running with the guys that have always been the fast guys, it was an honor to do that. But it kind of flips a different switch. You know, you all of a sudden you're more competitive, and in the driver's seat you want to be a little better there. And you know, we're drag racers and we're competitive. Just like any other sport, we want to always be better, run faster, and just do whatever we got to do to be the best.
Morgan, NASCAR has a little different situation. Obviously, we just read, by the way, some of the salaries. What was that top salary, Tom?
Dale Earnhardt Jr. made $25.9 million last year.
That's about what Morgan makes, I think, on his salary.
Yeah, pretty close. Believe me, if we were making that kind of money, that would be a pretty sweet gig, but to be honest with you, I think for the majority of us in drag racing, we don't do it for the money.
Yeah, obviously. And so obviously, you know, you're out there digging and trying to do the best you can. The cars cost money, nothing like a NASCAR, but what does it cost you to keep a car running all year long?
You know, somewhere in the $3.5 million range a year. It depends on some of the amenities you have, like hospitality, your shop space, and the equipment that you have to kind of keep your R&D and technology growing and go in the right direction. But for us, I would say it's a ballpark.
In your case, you have a pretty good sponsor, I'd say.
Yeah, I know. I got a couple.
Yeah.
And Geico takes really good care of us, and Lucas Oil takes really good care of the team as well.
And you have a little more sway with, I think, Lucas probably than you do. But for those who don't know, he's related to the Lucas family, Lucas Oil, of course, the arena in Indy. We talked about that last time. And so, how long are you going to do this thing? You got your finances secured. How old are you now, Morgan?
I'll be 30 in November.
Okay, so how long is a drag racer race?
Yeah, there's potential where you can run for a really long time, but I don't know exactly what the answer is to that right now, because at some point I'd really like to be really heavily involved in the family business, and you know, you don't really know where things are going to go. You just kind of have to just enjoy everything while it lasts, and you know, the plan is to always have a race car team out there, whether I'm driving or not, and make sure we keep these guys that are keeping us supported and employed, and just keeping the progress growing, because this is such a team that we really work hard on getting the right people involved and getting the teams to the point that we're at now, and it's not something we want to see go away.
We're talking with Morgan Lucas, the defending champion of the Gator Nationals at Top Fuel Division. Last year, Morgan, let's switch gears for a minute. Last year we were talking to you and found out you were an avid sports fan, really into football, and that you and the guys in the garage had a very competitive fantasy league. Did you win your fantasy league this year?
No, I did not. This year it was a bust. I got a lot of people that got hurt.
Was Andrew Luck on Morgan Lucas's team this year?
He actually was, and he actually was the I would say the most solid guy on the team.
So, but now, how do you, because you're a football guy, how do you size up the Colts coming back this year now with Andrew Luck getting in his sophomore year?
Well, free agency is any, you know, I guess, signed for everything. They've done a great job. They picked up some big players. They needed some meat on the offensive line. They also needed some meat on the defensive side of the ball, and I think they've done a good job picking up some really good players that I think were underrated. And I think coming to Indianapolis, they're going to be able to show their potential in the kind of defense and the defensive-minded team that Pagano has. And I think having a new offensive coordinator that Luck's already worked with coming out of Stanford, I think that's going to help. I don't know what's going to happen, and there might still be some growing pains, but after last year, I'm sure everybody in the city's got some really high hopes for him.
Final question for Morgan Lucas. I know it's kind of tough when a player leaves, like LeBron left Cleveland, whatever, and of course, in this particular case, it wasn't Peyton's decision. What are your feelings toward Peyton Manning, and what does the community feel toward him?
No, I think Peyton Manning is going to go down in history as being, I'd say, top three quarterbacks ever were to play the game. But I don't know, you know, as far as a person, I think he's a great person. I think he's a good businessman, and I think it's awesome what he's done in Denver, because majority of the quarterbacks that are kind of at their peak and then go to play for a different team, they seem like they don't ever get back to the game that they were at. And seeing how he played last year and just seeing how his mind works, it's really impressive.
Well, Morgan, we thank you so much for taking time out. I know you're busy over there in Gainesville getting ready for the Gator Nationals, and I'll be over there trackside this weekend watching all the power. I'll stop by. Maybe you'll take a little time out to say, hey, I know that guy right there, so I can impress some of my friends, because I need to.
And I look forward to it.
I
need to impress the one friend I got. So, but Morgan, good luck to you. And after you win this weekend, you'll come back on next week, as is tradition?
That would be great, honestly. If we can win again, I'd love to be back on the show, that's for sure.
All right, thanks so much, Morgan.
Good luck, Morgan.
Thank you, guys.
Morgan Lucas, defending champ at a Gator Nationals top fuel division, and an all-around good guy. I hung out with him for about an hour last year, and he didn't run me off with security, so I think he's a pretty good guy.
He obviously didn't know you very well. All right, coming up next, a different kind of racing. This is the four-legged kind with Michael Compton after this timeout on Buddy Sports Page.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, streaming live at WOCA.com. The Source.
Hi, this is Buddy Martin. I want to tell you about a conversation I had recently with General Manager Pat Murray on the great family atmosphere at Country Club of Ocala.
It's a family-first club. Again, we have any number of different types of memberships, but obviously the one that attracts the greatest level of interest is our family. And the reason for that is we have a little something for everybody. I mean, we obviously have a world-class golf course. We have 7 tennis courts here for all levels of tennis players. We have a junior Olympic-sized swimming pool. We have a fitness center that's second to none, and we have state-of-the-art equipment in our fitness center.
Country Club of Ocala, where the facilities are all a family would ever need. For more information, call today at 352-237-6644. That's 352-237-6644. Country Club of Ocala, proud sponsor of Monday's Gator Report and Gator Talk Thursday right here on The Source.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And so is State Farm agent Angie Lewis, working hard to serve her community as a citizen and insurance agent. Angie wants to help you as you adjust your insurance needs to your life, from everything to helping educate your teen driver to protecting your family against everyday risk. She wants to change the way you perceive insurance by developing relationships with her clients, which is why Angie and her staff are proud to be a part of so many good causes in Ocala. In turn, she has chosen to single out those who step up as leaders. Each month on The Voice of Ocala, Angie spotlights a good neighbor, saluting those who give exceptional service or do random acts of kindness to others. For this, Angie was written up in State Farm's National Magazine. Angie also supports local businesses with a regular Biz Buzz. The Angie Lewis State Farm Agency is located at 1122 Northeast 36th Avenue, where visitors are always welcome and a coffee pot is always on. Call your good neighbor's State Farm agent today, Angie Lewis, at 294-2444.
Call me crazy. Some people say insanity is doing the same thing over and over, expecting a different result. I think insanity is 1,000 single-sided, full-color business cards for $15 or packing service for 50% off. Call me crazy. Regency Printing, on the corner of Northeast 25th Avenue and 24th Street, 789-6683. That's 789-6683. Look for the yellow signs.
Hey, Matt, I know Sunrise Automotive does auto stuff, but I need some tires for my truck. Can you recommend someone?
Yes, I can. We do that.
No, I mean, I need them installed and balanced and all that.
Yep, we do that.
Well, my son needed his windows tinted.
Yep, we do that,
I need my seat replaced.
Yep, we do that, too.
I need a new roofline, a new spoiler, and a new
truck. Yep, we can even do that, too.
Okay, I get it. I suppose you can also do a radio show, too, huh?
Well, as a matter of fact, join me every Monday at 10 for auto repair with personal care here on The Source.
Of course you do.
Right now, somewhere in the world, there is a bear waking up from a long winter's hibernation. Scientists are not 100% sure how a bear knows winter is over, but I think I may have an explanation. Here it is. Spring comes to Florida first, so Florida gardeners get that spring fever first and head over to Kenny's Place Nursery. They go to Kenny's Place for gazanias, impatiens, geraniums, and begonias, all for 99 cents each. They also head to Kenny's Place Nursery for pansies, selling for 4 for a dollar. Now, that is a honey of a deal. Well, the thought of the honey reminds those gardeners of the special role pollinators, like bees, have in the garden. Now, every bear knows that where there are bees, there is honey. So, their noses wiggle, their ears twitch, and boom, the bear wakes up. And all because of a great sale at Kenny's Place Nursery. Who knew? Kenny's Place Nursery is located at 7677 Southeast 41st Court in Ocala. Give them a call at 867-1213. It's a honey of a deal at Kenny's Place.
Good credits, bad credits.
It's none of our business
because we're not an auto dealer. We're not a bank. We're not
your mother.
We're OcalaForSale.com, Marion County's marketplace for cars, trucks, and SUVs. We've got thousands of sellers standing by to take your call. No middleman. But hurry, don't walk, don't run. Just sit down and log on to OcalaForSale.com.
Prices and inventory change daily. Offer does not include dealer upcharge. Undercutting, rust proofing, factory surcharge, or delivery fee. See website for details.
You see your difference.
Welcome back to the program, Voice of Ocala. Buddy Martin's sports page, and now we're going out live to Michael Compton, the horse man, the guy who knows all about horses and almost anybody, and a little bit about sports, not so much the Lakers, though.
No.
All right, go ahead and get it out before you start out. You want to whine about your boy Kobe getting hurt?
No, like I was telling you, I've still got to watch the replay. But, you know, Kobe's known for throwing his body around. I didn't get to see the play, so I can't really comment.
Well, what happened was is the guy guarding him got a little close, and Kobe came down on his foot and strained his ankle and sprained his right. ankle. And he's had – is it Dante? Is that his name?
Dante Jones.
Dante Jones, yeah. Jones had a previous history where he had actually pushed him in the back once before and tripped him once. When we played for Denver, so there was a little history, but anyway, yeah. probably more made up. But Kobe did say he played dirty, so
yeah.
But your Lakers—that's
good enough for me.
I like his style.
Oh yeah. So speaking of horses, from the horse's mouth. Huh? All right, so I have this horse called Golden Sense, and Tom has one called Flashback, and now there's this horse called Hear the Ghost, and it right. must have been a ghost coach. So where'd he come from to beat our horses?
Yeah, I don't. You guys, both of your horses, you know, they carried the best credentials into the race, mm-hmm. and you know, I'm not one to blame jockeys that often. I know a lot of owners and trainers like to. It's easy to do, but those two jocks, they got carried away in a bit of a match race, and I don't think they really looked at the other contenders in the race as a threat to them. So they probably figured it didn't matter how fast they went on the lead. And those two hooked up, you know, way early in the race, and it just took too much out of them. Flashback held on, you know, the better of the two, but the early pace was just way too quick. And we've talked about that a lot, you know, on previous shows. Horses, when they go too fast early, it's hard to have a lot in reserve late. It's the equivalent of an athlete giving so much maybe in the early innings of a baseball game or a basketball game and not having quite enough to get through the whole season or get through a game.
One thing you can't do that at the Belmont. That's instant death, and even some of these shorter tracks. So what do our horses have in their breeding? Do they have the distance or not if they get to that point?
Yeah, both of those horses are fine on a breeding front. It's just a matter of this was, you know, the circumstances. I still think it's too early to write either one of them off. What I would have wanted to see from Flashback, you know, he's more inexperienced than Golden Sense is. Golden Sense raced a lot as a two-year-old. He's proven. He shipped to New York. He ran well as a two-year-old. So he has a bit more of a foundation. They say, you know, he has more training, he has more race experience. Flashback was a horse that has shown just a tremendous amount of raw talent. But what you would have wanted to see from him, and I'm sure what Baffert wanted to see from him, was the ability to rate and relax just a little bit. That is, have the horse in front of you in your sights, but not have to rush up and go head and head with that horse to prove you're the best. And you know, Julian Leperoux on Flashback wasn't really able to get Flashback to relax, which if you're going to win the Kentucky Derby, you have to have that dimension.
Speaking of Baffert, Bob Baffert was at the dinner Monday night with Florida Thoroughbred Breeders, and he got up and said some really nice things about Florida horses, which of
Terrific.
Course was understandable that, you know, that he'd want to do in a situation like that. But he did say, I mean, an awful nice living, he said, and mostly I buy Florida horses. How important is that to the breeding around here?
Oh, so important. That reputation, to have a guy like Baffert who's in the spotlight, you know, week in and week out, year in and year out, in all of the marquee races around the country and sometimes around the world, that's very important. That reputation that Florida breds have, they can compete with horses from anywhere around the globe, and they do, and it's a definitely deserved reputation, because I spent a lot of time in California before we came here 12 years ago. The horses in California do very well in California. They don't do very well against breed, you know, horses from Kentucky and Florida and New York on a regular basis, and horses from Florida can compete against the best anywhere.
Well, we're talking with Michael Compton, Michael Tom Schmitz here. Speaking of horses from Florida, the OBS, the Ocala Breeder Sales, underway. $1.8 million for a colt, ties a record. What is? Please explain that.
Well, that was that a was Kentucky
it was
horse.
A great sale. Yeah, great sale here the last 2 days, Tuesday and Wednesday at OBS. And as you guys know, it kicks off the juvenile sale season, the two-year-olds in training. These horses are ready to go become racehorses tomorrow. You know, these are the horses that are ahead of their peers at this point. They're the cream of the crop, the horses that were offered this week. And The sale topper yesterday, $1.8 million. Interviewing the man who bought the horse for Stone Street Stables immediately after he signed the ticket on the horse, he said he was a little shocked. He wasn't quite sure the horse was worth that much, but that's what happens at these auctions when you get hooked up in a bidding duel. And a few different entities were on that horse, and everybody wanted him. So it's great for the consigner and the owner of the horse when you see that materialize, and that's exactly what happened yesterday. You know, the people that ended up walking away with the horse didn't think they'd even have to go that high to get him, but he was quite the looker. I mean, this horse was handsome. He looked athletic, just looked like an athlete, just, you know, one of those horses that just stands out from the crowd, and a racehorse. He's ready to go.
The other side of that was Michael O'Farrell was talking the other day about a horse. I guess he won $3 million or something, and Michael pointed out that he sold him for $11,000. So he said, we got to do a little bit better than that, you know?
Right, and it often goes that way, too. Yeah. It's such an inexact science, yes.
Well, Michael, now, with our horses racing last weekend, what races are on the horizon to get us closer to the Kentucky Derby?
Yeah, you know, the other race last weekend was at Tampa Bay Downs, the Tampa Bay Derby, and Verrazano, who we talked a little bit about last week on the show, he's a horse that I liken to Flashback quite a bit. They both have very few starts, but a lot of raw talent. Verrazano fared a little better than Flashback did, and he had everything against him down there at Tampa. He had, you know, when you're a heavy favorite like he was, most of the other jockeys in the race are, you know, you have a bullseye on your back, so to speak, and they were well aware of Verrazano's presence the whole way, so they kind of try to dictate a tough trip for you, but Verrazano was just much the best, and his jockey was able to get him clear, and he was very impressive in that race. The jockey, John Velasquez, told me after the race that he didn't think that the horse really handled the track that well, so the fact that he won and remained undefeated, you know, with another prep race to go in the Wood Memorial at Aqueduct the first week of April before the Derby, he definitely has to be high on everybody's list. This weekend is the Rebel Stakes. It's at Oaklawn Park in Arkansas. And, Buddy, you're always asking about the Florida Bred getting ready for the Triple Crown Trail, and we've been quiet, but Baffert has a Florida Bred named Din's Legacy who will be trying to earn enough points to get to the Derby on Saturday.
That'd be nice to have one for a change, you know? Need to get us a Florida horse. By the way, the difference in Verrazano and Flashback is that Flashback has the burden of having Tom Schmitz on his back. So that's, you know, that's a lot of pressure.
I'm losing weight, pal. I'm losing weight. The horse may be able to carry me.
Baffert will hate to hear that's why he ran poorly. That's my Kaufman's fault. Trying to step out and get you guys excited about it.
Yeah. You know, Baffert hadn't had a whole bunch of success recently. What was his last big opera? Was it Silver Charm? What was his last big?
Oh, definitely on the Derby. But, you know, he has a horse named Game On Dude right now that just won the Santa Anita Handicap, and he traveled to Dubai last year in the Dubai World Cup, and Game On Dude's one of the best older horses in the business right now, and he'll likely be one of the favorites for the Breeders' Cup Classic at the end of the year.
He came very within an eyelash that day of having a Triple Crown winner if Touch Gold didn't come around that side on Silver Charm.
Silver Charm never saw him.
Never saw him. Had blinders. I was standing right there with Diane Dudley at the finish line at the Belmont, and what talk about a heartache. Man, come that far all the way to the very last 3 or 4 feet and you lose a Triple Crown. Wow.
And what a great story that would have been for Ocala.
Oh,
and
yeah.
Florida too. You know, we still go back to Affirm being the last one, and then he's a Florida bred, but if Silver Charm could have gotten that done, wow, what a feather in the cap for Florida breeding. Yeah
we still got it. We well, like Bogey said in Casablanca, we'll always have Affirmed.
You know? Always Affirmed and Needles. Never take those away.
Exactly. And Carry Back. So sure. Michael, anything else before we wrap it up on this segment? When are you going on the road?
Well, we'll be down at the Florida Derby at the end of this month, and I'll be up probably covering the Preakness with the Blood Horse this year. But until then, it's just going to be here in Florida. And like I said, we'll get through the Florida Derby and get up and cover some of those Triple Crown races.
Very first time I ever covered any kind of sporting event as a young Cub sports writer at age 20. I went down to Gulfstream to cover the Florida Derby, had no clue what I was doing. Luckily, but for a reporter in Washington, D.C.
40-something years later.
Yeah, or more.
Still the same.
And I'll tell you the story sometime. Michael, thanks so much, buddy.
Love to hear it. All right, you guys.
Take care.
Yeah, 40-something years later, you still have very little clue.
I have a little more clue about horse racing.
Clue about doing this job, or you wouldn't have me in here on the radio.
Oh, okay. Well, the bottom line is I didn't know how to write a story. That was first and foremost. I didn't know how to do it. I didn't know how to send a story. You had to slug your story a certain way. In those days, Western Union. And I didn't know what was important to go in a horse racing story. I didn't know it was important to put the prices when places show. I just didn't have any idea how to write the story. I mean,
I understand, because the Mr. Golf column you have me writing for your
kind of where I was.
Well, you had to send me an email. You know this. You had to send me an email to tell me what font to use.
Well,
that's how bad off I was.
We didn't have fonts, and we just had typewriters.
Right,
it didn't matter. But no, for sure. But I mean, you, how, where you are right now compared to where I was then, you were probably advanced on me at that point. So, all right, we'll take a break. Come back. We'll talk to Franz Beard next about the Florida Gators after this timeout on the Voice of Ocala.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, streaming live at WOCA.com, the source.
Hi, I'm Lisa Midget with Kinetic Motion Fitness, Ocala's premier small group and personal training fitness studio. Did you know you can achieve all your fitness goals, whether that's losing weight, getting fit, or training for a personal best, all with no membership fees? Have you ever been embarrassed or intimidated at a big gym because you're not a Greek god or a size zero supermodel? Have you ever felt like your gym would rather you not even show up? At KMF, we have a team approach that focuses on small classes and personal training, and you'll feel like family, not just another number. No more boring treadmills or endless reps. Our classes are fun, energetic, and get you the results you want. And I should know, with the help of our great trainers, I lost over 100 pounds in 8 jean sizes, and I did it using no heavy equipment and no magic pills, just fun and effective workouts. And yes, I did say fun. Come join us at KMF. Visit our website at kmfocala.com or like us on Facebook. Again, that was kmfocala.com.
Marsh Bank approval. Vehicle purchase across the fixed rate allowance offers no combined.
Are you bored, tired, and disgusted with your old car?
Hey, this is Cupid, Chris Spears from Prestige Auto Sales. I want you to love your car, so trade in the old car you hate.
Even if you're still making payments. Even if you owe more than it's worth.
And I'll help you drive a nicer, newer car sooner than you ever thought possible. Plus, when you use your tax refund as a down payment, you'll get a lot nicer, newer car. So you can hook up with a car you love today.
Bad credit? Cupid got you down? Our For the People credit approval specialists are world-class matchmakers. They'll connect you with the lender most likely to approve your loan.
Hate your old car?
Dump it. And fall in love with a nicer, newer car today, even if you owe more than it's worth or still making payments. Plus, turn your tax refund into your down payment and save a lot on a car you'll love.
Hurry, this love fest ends when we match 57 people with a car of their dreams. I'm Chris Spears, and I'm a dealer for the people. Visit me in Ocala or Bellevue.
Online at PrestigeSaysYes.com.
Or call 694-1234. See you at Prestige.
On the next AM Ocala Live, Robin and I have a first. We have a little bit of a mystery on our hands. We had a publicist call us and told us that a prominent philosopher and scientist wanted to be on our show, but did not want to reveal his name. So he's got a pen name, Dorian Alexander. Why we can't know his real name is a mystery. Dorian Alexander, or whoever he is, has written a book called Zarathustra Must Die. I guess we'll find out together.
Open for debate, where the listeners get to choose the topics.
And on Winging It, Brad Brosma and Josh Verdonk will tell you what it takes to become a pilot. They come in from Ocala Aviation Flight School.
John Sotomayor is the executive editor of Ocala Magazine. He will be on his show with his guests at Ocala Magazine Radio.
And then Carl F. Hobart will be on with us speaking about his book, Raising Global IQ.
Dr. Eugene Fisher has written a book called The Saint for Shalom, How Pope John Paul II Transformed Catholic-Jewish Relations.
And then Susan Benjamin Feingold is coming on, a psychologist specializing in antepartum and postpartum depression. Her book, Happy Endings, New Beginnings. All of that plus fun with Joe right here on The Source.
If you want to avoid getting ripped off and put more money in your pocket, then join me, Clark Howard, every weeknight at 6, right here on WOCA, The Source.
Phoenix Promotional Solutions, your company supplier of banners, digital decals, yard signs, and magnetic signs. Where you give them approved artwork by noon, the next day by 4 p.m., you pick up your banners, digital decals, yard signs, and magnetic signs. Phoenix Promotional Solutions, 368-2404. That's 368-2404. Don't forget, they do vehicle wraps also. Phoenix Promotional Solutions, 368-2404.
WOCA.
WOCA. News Talk 1370. Good talk, great conversation.
All right, back in the program. Time to talk a little about the hoops now. We got the games underway. JJ, update us on what you got there in basketball as we're talking to Franz. I know you'll be getting that Miami
score.
The
Gators played LSU.
LSU tomorrow.
Miami plays Boston College.
Yeah, 1 o'clock they play tomorrow, I think.
1 o'clock. All right, we'll find out from the man who knows something about it, Franz Beard. Franz, how are you, buddy?
Doing well, thanks, buddy. Life's good. Life's good here in Hogtown.
Yeah, Hogtown, not in Arkansas, but in Gainesville, for those who don't know. what do you anticipate on this Florida team tomorrow?
Well, they're playing an LSU team that I think is a better matchup for them than Georgia. The way Georgia was playing recently, I think Georgia would have caused them some problems. LSU is going to be a better matchup. They're still going to have to contain Johnny O'Brien in the middle, but Florida's got more length than LSU on the wings, and they can stop the 3-point shooting. So this should be a good confidence building win. And it's going to set the stage probably for a rematch with Tennessee, and that's going to be a heck of a ball game.
Tennessee is so athletic, I tell you, they really are. I read a story, I guess today, from on Kevin Brockway's story in the Star Banner or the Gainesville Sun, I forget which, and he talked about the psychological aspect of whether or not Florida's in a bad place mentally. And Billy Donovan was quoted as saying it's not mental. It's not like they're afraid or they're freezing up, because you see those guys taking the ball in there, you know, in the paint, and you see Wilbekin making left-handed passes. He said Wilbekin would never get, you know, he's always overconfident, if anything. He says, I think if anything, it's not lack of confidence, it's overconfidence. Do you agree with that?
He could be onto something. They beat so many teams badly that it's almost like they go out there expecting to blow people out, and it can be a problem if you think that way. If you go in there and you take people lightly, I can't say that necessarily they've taken people lightly, because that doesn't explain what happened to them. For example, down the stretch of these games, they have been losing games in the last 5 minutes. That's when they've been losing games. And there's been a common theme of how they've lost games in the last 5 minutes, which is bad shot selection, turnovers, and defensive lapses. Now, whether that's a case, I think more of it is on the fact that they went throughout most of February without Casey Prather and without Will Yeget. And because of that, I think they had to change their rotation. I think they lost their chemistry. And that's what I think is the biggest
we talked
problem.
About that some last Monday, and the fact that they could have bad, tired legs. Chemistry is certainly that's part of it. But this, you hit on the problem. We got about a minute here, but the problem is this was a pattern they had where they lost mm-hmm. those games. It was all the same. Games they should have won, games they led, games they gave away, kicked it away, had the opportunity, couldn't make a shot, looked like they lost their composure. And that's the thing that would be concerned me, is that there's definitely a pattern there. The question is, can they break that pattern? We got 45 seconds.
Well, they're going to have to. And the thing that scares you about it is, you look back at the last 2 years, late in games, they had Irving Walker, and I know a lot of people are saying, wow, I'm glad we don't have Irving Walker anymore. I know a lot of people think that. But Irving Walker was not afraid to have the ball and take the last shot. They've got guys now that don't want that last shot, it seems to me. Irving wanted it, and the year before they had Chandler Parsons, who was another one who wasn't afraid to take the last shot. He knew if he made it, everybody would love him. He knew if he missed it, everybody would be down on him, but he wasn't afraid to do it. And I don't know if they have a guy that wants to take the last shot. I don't know if they have a guy that wants the ball in his hands in the last 5 minutes when the pressure's on.
Closest to it might be Rosario. Franz, thank you very much. We'll talk to you on Monday, all right? Have a good weekend.
Yes, indeedy.
Franz Beard reports on every Monday and Thursday, brought to you by Country Club Ocala. The Gator Report. We'll talk more about football.